It is almost party time in Shreveport. Ole Miss, Oklahoma, the Samford Independence Bowl. Hi, everyone. I'm Rich Waltz. Welcome to Shreveport. It's the final college football game of the century. And appropriate that we have these two schools who started football in the late 1800s. They've combined in this last century for 9 national championships. And guess what? They have never met on the football field. And Gino Toretta, I think things are pretty good for the next century as well. These are two rising programs.
They're going to get started off on the right foot. Both these programs turning it around. Whoever wins this game, off to a good Y2K.
Hey, Oklahoma's doing it not the old-fashioned way. They're doing it through the air. Josh Heupel, their quarterback's a good one.
Josh Heupel, one of the best quarterbacks, Big 12, offensive newcomer of the year, does it through the air, very accurate passer.
His coach brought the fun and gun system from Florida. Bob Stoops was Steve Spurrier's defensive coordinator. David Cutcliffe at Ole Miss does it on the ground, at least for now. And he told us the good things happen when he gets the ball to Deuce.
Deuce McAllister, the most fastest player on Ole Miss team. Outstanding receiver out of the backfield. Great kick returner. Good things happen when number 22 has a big day. So look for Deuce to get the ball early and often. Averages over 8 yards every time he touches the football.
Both of these teams come in at 7-4. Neither of these teams were blown out this year. All of their losses, close ones. It's downright balmy in Shreveport. It feels like October, not New Year's Eve. We have an outstanding night for the final college football game of this century. A sold-out Independence Stadium. Tim Duncan will kick it off for the Sooners. McAllister dragged down at the 8-yard line, and a good start for Oklahoma. Ole Miss's quarterback is a good one. Romero Miller is a junior. He completed 54% of his passes. Gino, what are we looking for from this kid tonight?
They have to take pressure off Romero Miller. Deuce McAllister has to start up early. That'll open up the play-action pass. They can't rely on Miller to throw the ball 30 to 40 times to win this football game.
From his own 8. He will throw it. McAllister. Deuce across the 15. Bounced out of bounds at the 16. 8-yard pickup. Our Sun Microsystems starting lineups for Ole Miss. Second in the SEC in rushing. And Deuce McAllister will get blocking from Charles Stackhouse. It's a pro-type set. Good receivers in Maurice Flournoy and Corey Peterson. They don't throw to Bettis often at all. It's a very young offensive line, but they only gave up 16 sacks. A very good run-blocking offensive line. No gain on that carry. Ryan Fisher made the stop for Oklahoma. The Sooners defense, 7th overall in the Big 12 conference. It's a 4-3 look. Up front, the men to watch, the guys in the middle. Barry Holloman and Ryan Fisher. 31 sacks for this group. The linebackers are really good. Torrence Marshall, 7 sacks, leads the team. Rocky Kalmus leads in tackles. The corners are the best, many people feel, in the Big 12. Barty and Woods, that pair good. Liddell and Williams, the safeties. Very close to the first down. Torrence Marshall and Rocky Kalmus, the two linebackers, made the stop.
Rich, Ole Miss has come out and did just as we expected. Get the ball to Deuce McAllister, whether on the swing pass out of the backfield as a receiver or running the football. I think for Ole Miss to be successful, I'd rather see him throw the football to 22 than running in there tight.
It sounds strange to say it, Gino, but Oklahoma hasn't really seen a running offense like this that often in the Big 12 this year.
There's a lot of new coaches, a lot of new teams in this conference. So the Big 12, traditionally known for running the football. Most of them like throwing the football now.
David Cutcliffe in his first year, but not his first Independence Bowl. He coached this team in the Independence Bowl last year when he took over for Tommy Tuberville and won it in an upset over Texas Tech. Miller on first and 10. In trouble. Throwing to the sidelines. And incomplete. Corey Heinicke was in hot pursuit of Romero Miller.
Even though that's an incompletion, Rich, a good play by Romero Miller. There's nobody there. Oklahoma's pressuring. They're bringing the blitz. Miller able to break contain and throw that football away. You have to look at that. Ole Miss has to look at that as a positive play.
Bob Stoops, one of the bright young coaches in college football, 39 years of age, 3 years the defensive coordinator at Florida, spent 7 years at Kansas State. And what a first year he's had in Norman. Straight ahead with the fullback, Charles Stackhouse. Ryan Fisher, Corey Callens made the stop.
Fisher and Holloman have established their line of scrimmage early, Rich. They're not letting Ole Miss push them off the football. So what's Ole Miss going to have to do? They're going to have to try to pitch the ball, break contain, get outside, run the football as opposed to running it inside the tackles.
And a four-receiver set. On third and 9, Sooners show blitz. And here they come. Miller, deflected, incomplete. Torrance Marshall on the blitz. And Oklahoma's defense holds.
Good coverage by Torrance Marshall and Romero Miller. You can't try to jam that ball in there. That was tight coverage. Throw that football away and let your punt team come out here. You can't risk turnover this early in the ball game.
Reagan King is back to punt. Terrell Jackson, one of the more exciting punt returners in the Big 12, is deep. Jackson. Out to the 45-yard line. 47-yard punt, 11-yard return. Full house here in Shreveport, including Don McPherson.
That's right, Rich. It is a full house. And when Bob Stoops came to Norman, he did more than just bring an exciting offense and restore a great tradition in Oklahoma. He brought excitement back to the fans here. And when they announced that they were going to play in the Independence Bowl, they sold out in the first day. In fact, 31,000 fans have come to Shreveport to ring in the new year with their Sooners.
And now our first look at this Oklahoma offense. Receivers. And it's a give to Quentin Griffin, who breaks a tackle and another, and he's down to the 42-yard line. 13 yards on the pickup. Our son Mike Sisson, starting lineup for Oklahoma. Josh Heupel, the trigger man. Quentin Griffin just got the football. You'll see some of these backs, but mostly you'll see a three, sometimes four receiver set. Curtis Fagan, Jarrell Jackson, and Brandon Daniels. Daniels is your big play guy, 50 catches this year. Offensive line, very good. Romero, Smith, O'Neill, Bertram, and McDougal. Josh Heupel got his man at the 32. Jarrell Jackson. Tim Strickland on the coverage. The Rebels are decent against the pass. They did set a record, this front four, with 38 sacks, third in the SEC this year. The linebackers are good. Armijah Spearman is sort of the spiritual leader of this team. Eddie Strong is the leading tackler. Corners are pretty good. Lucas and Strickland. Hurd and Taylor are the safeties. 11 yards on that pickup. Heupel, a quick throw, and it's caught. Brandon Daniels. And the Sooner Express is rolling. 14 yards on that pickup.
Josh Heupel, Coach Stoops, and the offensive coordinator, Mark Mangino, told us he's a very hardworking quarterback, very studious. Reminds Stoops a lot of when Danny Werfel was at the University of Florida. A good quarterback to be compared to.
Three plays, three first downs. The kid from Aberdeen, South Dakota, Josh Heupel, with time, throwing. Broken up at the two. Seneca Taylor on the coverage of Trent Smith, the tight end.
And Josh Heupel came to Trent Smith late. Trent Smith was running right down the middle of the field, wide open. Didn't hit the receiver early, and Seneca Taylor able to come across and bat the ball down. Here you see in the shotgun formation, looking to the left, not his primary receiver. Trent Smith comes to him late, gives Taylor a chance to come and bat the ball down.
On second down, blitz coming to the end zone, and too far for Jackson. Gino, Josh Heupel, for many college football fans, sort of came out of nowhere. Here's a kid that went to Snow Junior College after he started his collegiate career at Weber State University in the Big Sky Conference, a 1AA school. And when Bob Stoops saw him on film, he liked him. And it was Mike Leach, the offensive coordinator, that brought him here. Leach, of course, has left Oklahoma to be the head coach at Houston. He is not here tonight. Heupel's throw deflected. Sooners want interference. Tim Strickland made the play.
Rich, going back to your point, Josh Heupel, sometimes in recruiting, players fall through the cracks. There you see them. Throws a little high. Good coverage by Strickland. But Heupel just may have fallen through the cracks a little bit. Recruiting processes aren't perfect for every school, and sometimes it takes a film sent by yourself to get recruited, and that's what Heupel did.
35 yards for Tim Duncan. Missed it. So the Sooners not on the board yet. Ole Miss and Oklahoma in Shreveport.
Sharpie, mark whatever you want.
Unleash power, sell more per hour, get business going, keep it growing, change ammunition, kill competition, unlock data, make profits fatter, take sharper aim, boost market gain, save more time, more peace of mind, forge better ties, economize, link devices without a crisis, our technology is hot, we are the dot.
Day 82. Coldest day yet. Even the dogs won't move. Still no radio contact and supplies are running low.
I brought you some cookies and some nice hot cocoa. Bye-bye, dear.
No matter how bad conditions get, there are a few things you can always count on. The Go Anywhere Jeep Cherokee is just one of them. Now get a Cherokee and get all these features at no extra charge.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 1999 Sanford Independence Bowl is presented by Sharpie Permanent Markers from Sanford. Mark whatever you want. And in part by Jeep, makers of Grand Cherokee, Cherokee, and Wrangler.
Binion's Horseshoe right on the river in downtown Shreveport. Bob Stoops. His offense gets the headlines, but Gino, he's made his living as a defensive guy, and this is a good defense.
It's a good defense, and people don't realize Oklahoma's 15 points away from being undefeated at 11-0.
And Miller. Sanford with the catch. William Barty made the hit. 7 yards on the pickup toward Sanford, the freshman. Both of these teams have had good seasons, but you know the margin here, Ole Miss 15, Oklahoma 38, neither team's been blown out this year.
And that's a credit to both of these coaches. As a first-year coach, I was in the same thing happened to me at the University of Miami. Jimmy Johnson left, Dennis Erickson came in. Players have to buy into these coaches' systems, and they did it early. And that's going to be a great asset, and it's a tremendous asset to these coaches to have your players believe in you in their first season.
Little Joe Gunn picks up the first down for Ole Miss. Corey Heineke made the stop. There's a look at Gunn. We told you about McAllister, but Joe Gunn has 6 100-yard games from his running back spot this year.
And David Cutcliffe told us Gunn and McAllister are very complementary of each other. So not to say one can have a great game by himself. They both rely on each other to have a good game.
Miller holding, throwing, open is Flournoy. He's got it. At the 25. 45-yard pickup, Maurice Flournoy with the catch.
And Cutcliffe, also a great offensive mind. You see Miller sit in the pocket, pump fake. Hits Flournoy deep down the sidelines. He's given Oklahoma a lot of different looks defensively, and they've had success. A super throw by Miller and a good catch by Maurice Flournoy.
Longest catch of the year for Flournoy. Ole Miss into Sooner territory for the first time. Miller. McAllister open, touchdown Rebels! Deuce is loose.
Another great call by David Cutcliffe. They fake the counter. And usually when that happens, the linebackers in man coverage, after a play action fake, they'll forget about the running back. I don't know how you can forget about McAllister, because he is your big play guy. But he's able to get behind the linebacker. Miller finds him.
Binkley with the extra point. The Rebels in the end zone first. Romero Miller, Deuce McAllister. It's 7-0.
A pen that's smooth from start to finish. Now that's amazing. Uniball. Smooth. Real smooth.
Everybody loves Sonic's famous tater tots. But not everybody loves eating them exactly the same way. No matter how you pop them, only Sonic's got them. Come grab some with our Burger and Tot Special. A Sonic burger made the way you love it, with a load of hot and crispy tots for a special low price. Hey, how you eat them is your business. You'll love the way we do things.
Sonic America's driving.
A significant discovery in eye health may be lutein, a nutrient found in these healthy foods. Now Centrum has the only leading multivitamins with lutein to help maintain your precious sight. Centrum, Centrum Silver, now more complete with lutein.
To make a connection with a pen that's truly smooth? Uniball. Smooth. Real smooth.
It's Super January on ABC. SEC champion Alabama faces Michigan in the FedEx Orange Bowl.
There is the old MVP.
7-0. Ole Miss on top of Oklahoma.
Oklahoma comes up and wants to pressure and blitz Ole Miss. But what happens?
He'll be back.
You'll see Riddell, the safety. He's accountable for McAllister right here in man coverage. They make the play action fake, and Riddell steps up into the line of scrimmage. But after the fake, forgets about covering McAllister as a pass receiver, and he gets by him. Romero Miller finds him over the top for the 6 points.
Jackson. Terrell Jackson out to the 21. And remember this, Gino, about Ole Miss coach David Cutcliffe, because we've only focused on the running game. But he was the guy that was the offensive coordinator at Tennessee, and he was the guy that many people credited. Obviously, he was a pretty talented guy to begin with much of Peyton Manning's success and that Tennessee Volunteer passing game.
Well, as the offensive coordinator, Tennessee had an outstanding success, especially with quarterbacks. Started with Andy Kelly. He sure, Peyton Manning and T. Martin. He had a hand in coaching all of them and a hand in all of their successes.
Sandwich and held on to it for a very painful 5-yard reception.
What Art Kaufman, the defensive coordinator for Ole Miss, is doing, he's giving Heupel and the Oklahoma offense all sorts of different looks. The receivers and the quarterback aren't sure if it's man coverage, if they're blitzing, if it's zone. That's what you have to do to a throwing offense. You have to confuse the quarterbacks and receivers on the particular coverage.
Heupel on a quick screen. Antoine Savage to the 30. That's short of the first down. It'll be third down and a long one.
The Oklahoma offense averaging over 36 points a game scoring. They're number 9 in the NC2A in passing. So we're going to see a lot of balls in the air tonight.
A long third and one here. Rebel show blitz. Come with four. First down, Damian Mackey. Tim Strickland on the coverage, 9-yard pickup.
That was a great job by Josh Heupel, sensing the pressure, getting out of the pocket, going to not his first or second read, going to his third receiver, and picking up the key first down.
First and 10 of the moment at the 39-yard line.
First and 10 now at the 38-yard line. Heupel's throw on the mark, dropped and picked up. It'll be a catch, a fumble, and an Ole Miss ball. Angie Williams
recovered the fumble, but credit Art Kaufman. Ole Miss shows blitz. Josh Heupel sees the safeties come down. He audibles to a good blitz throw and is received. The Ole Miss defense then changes, comes out of it, plays his own coverage, confuses Heupel. This is what Ole Miss is having good success. Art Kaufman's got a great game plan here today.
Tim Strickland with the hit. And Angie Williams, the recovery. McAllister. To the 18, 21 yards.
Rich, when David Cutcliffe started talking about Deuce McAllister's. I started lighting up and said, this kid is an outstanding football player. He's the type of player that used to be at the we used to coach at the University of Tennessee. Great receiver, great runner of the football. And he will be a legitimate Heisman candidate next year.
And most importantly, just like Tennessee, very fast.
Very fast, and that is the key ingredient.
Miller's in trouble. And he goes down at the 27. Barry Holloman. Along with Roger Steffen.
And don't think the Ole Miss defense is going to be the only one to pressure today. Oklahoma is going to come with a whole bunch of different blitz, whether it's a zone blitz, play zone behind a blitz, or they're going to play all-out man and bring everybody. Ole Miss is going to see as many variations of a defense as their offense is.
On second and 18. Screen pass. It's picked off! Heineke to the 20.
Ole Miss set up this screen beautifully. Romaro Miller takes a snap, takes a few steps, but there's one problem. Corey Heineke, here you see the defensive end. Watch the tackle. He doesn't get him cut, doesn't get him to the ground. Heineke fights off the block, intercepts the pass. And now we see the speed of McAllister run down Heineke.
And maybe saving 6 points. Sooners on the ground. Quentin Griffin, the 17-yard line.
In Romaro Miller's defense on that last play, it's awful to throw an interception on a screen, but I guarantee he did not even see Heineke, because when he's throwing that football, Heineke's on his knees trying to fight off a block and makes a very athletic play to intercept that football.
Quick throw is dropped. Seth Littrell is the intended receiver. It has been a great Circuit City Bowl week, and it ends tomorrow with the Outback Bowl. It all starts at 9:30 Eastern with game day. Then number 20 Purdue against number 24 Georgia. Drew Brees in Purdue. 11 a.m. Eastern, 8 a.m. Pacific. It's tomorrow on ESPN, your home for Bowl Week. Third and 7. Heupel. Deflected and incomplete. Chris Hammond, the junior out of Sulphur, Oklahoma. Couldn't hold it.
Oklahoma, just like the University of Florida, likes to run a lot of crossing routes underneath and get their players, their receivers, open in zone coverage. What Ole Miss is doing a good job of, they're bringing different players down in different zones and confusing Heupel. Unless the Oklahoma offense can figure out just what Ole Miss is doing, it looks to be they're going to get stopped like that every drive.
Jim Duncan missed from 35, this from 34, and this is good. Oklahoma on the scoreboard. The Sooners trail the Rebels 7-3.
Time. This woman comes to the door wearing a flimsy nightgown.
I brought her the Mazzio's dinner for two, and man, she was like 80. There's this thrifty family that always gets the dinner for four. Comes to like $4 each.
Which should allow for a nice tip.
Mazzio's dinner for a crowd feeds 8 people at less than $3 a head. One time I delivered to this sorority house. Let's just say the ladies love a man in uniform, which I am. Mazzio's, the pizza people crave.
Once a year, and only once a year, the Men's Warehouse has a sale. That's right. Only once a year do we further reduce our everyday low prices an additional 20 to 40%. Of course, one sale a year may not seem like a lot. But if it's a sale as big as this one, well, once is enough.
It takes a Men's Warehouse sale to beat a Men's Warehouse price.
You're gonna like the way you look. I guarantee it.
Displayed on the ice for all to see. Both Owen Nolan and Tony Amonte can use their sticks to create masterpieces. Sharks Blackhawks, Sunday at 8:30, only on ESPN. This is the game.
A new year. The usual suspects. Will Tiger Woods continue his reign, or will one of these marksmen steal the day? The PGA Tour kicks off the 2000 season in prime time with the Mercedes Championships. Coverage begins next Thursday at 7 on ESPN.
First night celebration in Oklahoma City. Things are just getting started. They're watching this game on the side of a building. From all you folks in Oklahoma City, your Sooners are on the board. Ole Miss and Oklahoma from a sold-out Independence Bowl. 7-3, the Rebels. Jim Duncan. McAllister, or rather Taylor. And Taylor is down at the 8-yard line. Let's go down below. Don McPherson.
Hey, Rich, both coaches on the sidelines are telling their teams to settle down. It seems like both defenses have come out and playing very aggressive. Oklahoma coaches were talking about settling down and recognizing the blitz, recognizing the pressures. Obviously, on this sideline, Mississippi has to settle down at that interception. It was a costly one, and they have to bounce back.
Quick throw to Peterson. And Corey Peterson is out to the 20-yard line.
And that little hitch route by Peterson will bring Miller start to regain his confidence. Oklahoma once again comes up with eight men in the box. They're going to pressure. Just a three-step quick throw. And Peterson able to pick up 9 yards.
Not a bad start for Miller, though the one pick was a big one. Charles Stackhouse, the carry.
And Rich, one thing I do like, David Cutcliffe coming right back out, letting Miller throw the football as a quarterback. Whenever I would throw an interception, I hated to go the next drive a couple plays without throwing the football again, saying, hey, I'm going to complete some passes, not make any more mistakes like that.
Cutcliffe serves as the offensive coordinator. While in motion, Miller was hit as he throws, and it's picked off, intercepted. William Barty. Torrance Marshall made the hit, and Barty had it thrown right at him.
Romaro Miller makes a huge mistake. He hopes his corner route is open. It's a corner route by his tight end. You'll see him out of the corner of your screen. He does not see the underneath coverage, throws the football, and Torrance Marshall just mauls Romaro Miller. And I think that's why the throw is inaccurate and why it was picked off.
And the Sooners are right back in business. The Ole Miss 29. To his tight end, Trent Smith. To the 26. It's a gain of only four.
Rich, one thing as a quarterback, with all the different looks Heupel's seeing from the Ole Miss defense, it's going to force him to hold that ball just that extra half of a second. And what does that do? That's going to create more sacks for the Ole Miss defense. So he's got to start getting into his own rhythm and start getting rid of the ball a little bit faster.
Griffin to the 23-yard line. Oklahoma averages just 105 yards a game on the ground. Dead last in the Big 12 Conference. But that's okay when you average 321 through the air, first in the Big 12.
You have to do one thing well, and Oklahoma throws it very well.
Ole Miss has too many men on the field. If they get the right number on before the snap. And third and five. Heupel lost it. Who's got it? Ole Miss says they do. And they do.
Rich, Art Kaufman has come out today with a super game plan for Ole Miss. Heupel sees blitz or an apparent blitz by the defense, changes the play, gets a little antsy, and forgets about getting the snap. There you see it looks like a good snap by the center, but he's anticipating getting the ball and maybe having a shot to go for the end zone, and Clancy able to recover the fumble.
Kendrick Clancy, the senior out of Tuscaloosa. Four turnovers already. And we've got 3 minutes left in the first quarter. Back to basics. Joe Dunn. Joe Dunn is a sophomore. Deuce McAllister is a junior. They'll both be back next year, and that's good news. Add the numbers up. They're averaging over 5 yards a carry every time they carry.
And Gunn with 600-yard games this season, and McAllister with four. But McAllister has been dinged up with a bad shoulder since 2 days, and he's just starting to regain his full health.
167 yards per game between the two. Miller to throw it. And completes it out to the 34-yard line. Jamie Armstrong. 4 yards on the pickup. Third down and short. And Geno, third and short for any team is important, but I think especially for Ole Miss.
Especially for Ole Miss. Look at that 38% conversion rate, but first and second down are a bigger key to this offense because they don't throw the ball 40 times like Oklahoma.
Complete, but what a great defensive play by Roy Williams.
Miller has to start taking what's there. He makes a good play action fake, boots around the corner, tries to force that ball, and Roy Williams comes up with a great defensive play. Watch when he makes the play action fake. He boots around the corner. He could have run for the yard. Picked up the first down, but tries to force that ball in there, and Williams almost picks it off.
Williams out of the San Francisco Bay Area, Union City, California. Reagan King. Jackson lets it bounce. And the Sooners will have good field position on a 30-yard punt. Weekend of the NFL, and it starts with Sunday NFL Countdown at 11 a.m. Eastern, 8 a.m. Pacific. Join Chris Berman and the gang. They'll preview the final weekend in the NFL. Then at 7:30, another edition of NFL Prime Time. Chris and Tom Jackson will have all the highlights from around the NFL to look ahead to the playoffs. Log on to ESPN.com. As you know, it's part of the Go Network. Go.com. Heupel, quick throw. Curtis Fagan on the screen. Ken Lucas came up and made the stop. 3 yards on the pickup.
Rich, the Ole Miss offense has to start capitalizing on these opportunities that their defense has given them. The Oklahoma offense is too dangerous to just keep giving them the ball back and not scoring points with these turnovers.
Probably a lot of the same stuff that David Cutcliffe is whispering into Romero Miller's ear right now. Point trouble. That one is almost intercepted, and that would have been 6 points. Justin Blake, the redshirt freshman, Tyler Williams on the pressure.
The Ole Miss defense is coming out, and they are hungry. Here you see just a little tackle and mix. That's a loop, and you see the guard and tackle don't communicate with each other. And Blake able to get in and pressure Josh Heupel.
Oklahoma looking at 3rd and 7 as the first quarter winds down. Blitz coming. Heupel caught. Trent Smith. First down Sooner. At Ole Miss, the 46-yard line of Ole Miss. Anthony McGee made the stop.
And a nice job by Heupel there. Stands in the face of that pressure. He knows the blitz is coming. He has confidence in his offensive line that they're going to pick up, know their assignments, find his tight end over the middle, Trent Smith.
On 1st and 10, a little shoveled pass to Griffin. 42. It's a gain of 4. Kamon Fisher made the stop. One quarter of the final football game of this century. It's in the books. Ole Miss and Oklahoma. Deuce McAllister with the only touchdown. It's 7-3 after one.
Mark whatever you want.
People are beginning to think of the automobile not just as a family vehicle, but as a personal and individual means of transportation.
The throb of a powerful engine. Now for a moment, imagine yourself as driver of this automobile.
You really have to drive it.
At the Chrysler Proving Ground.
Give them an expressway and their drivers are
well. I think we made the scenic back roads fun to drive.
Or give them any country or suburban road, rough or smooth. They're the type of people who like the feel of a fine machine.
Love to drive. The renowned engineers of Chrysler.
A minimum of ornamentation and a minimum of chrome moldings.
He's a regular firecracker.
The sounds of nature sing their prettiest over the rich, throaty obbligato of his engine.
Even sheet metal can have a soul.
And they give you back the romance of driving.
And that is why these will never land on an ordinary car.
And you find out what exceptional unity of man and machine has been achieved.
Hey, do you want a ride?
Sure.
You're going to have to squeeze in the back.
With us.
Okay.
Can life get any better than this?
We have an extra Wendy's Classic Double with Cheese. Do you want it?
Yes, it can.
We call it Hamburger Bliss.
When we asked some denture wearers why they don't use an adhesive, they didn't have a lot to say.
Don't need it.
My dentures fit fine.
No problems here.
But after we gave them Fixident, they just couldn't say enough.
It's amazing, the difference.
It's a great new feeling of security.
Comfort.
Confidence.
I just plain forget I have them.
That's because Fixident adjusts to the unique contours of your dentures and gums, forming a thin, powerful seal for a better hold than you ever thought possible.
I could just kick myself for not doing this sooner.
Find out for yourself what it feels like to Fixident and forget it.
Oklahoma traveled over 30,000 to this game. This place holds about 50,000, and it's full. Second and six. Heupel. Out of the backfield, Griffin. Short of the first down. Armijah Spearman made the stop. They weren't sure if Spearman would make it to the Independence Bowl. He didn't practice. He was injured the tail end of the regular season, but they're glad he's back.
And didn't get the bowl pre-practice. What that is, that time from their last game to Christmas break is bowl pre-practice. Then after Christmas, these teams will come back and fine-tune their game plans for the bowl event.
They're having trouble with the chains over on the sidelines. Now that they've straightened them out. That's such a concern, Gino, staying sharp. How did you guys do it at Miami for bowl preparation?
Practiced hard, Rich. I really think these bowl teams we're seeing, it's just been a little sloppy. These teams need to settle down and get in the groove.
Third down. Heupel. Caught. Dropped. And incomplete. Josh Norman is complete. Out of bounds. And short of the first down.
Rich, one thing we were fortunate to have at Miami, you need good leaders on teams. I think both of these ball clubs are a little young and don't really understand. This is Oklahoma's first bowl game since 1994, so they haven't been through the process. The more and more these players go through the process, the more refined their bowl game will be.
It's a fake. And it's picked off, now dropped, and that's a great play by Peterson. Had he caught it, the ball would have been marked where he was tackled. Instead, it's coming back to the line of scrimmage. A heads-up play by Corey Peterson of Ole Miss. Ole Miss on top of Oklahoma. The Rebels get it when we get back.
Mark whatever you want.
Light, heat, and time are all enemies of beer. We can protect the beer from light with a Braun bottle. We protect beer from heat by ensuring that we keep it in a temperature-controlled environment. We then make sure that the consumer enjoys that beer as soon as possible. We are the only major domestic brewer that uses a born-on dating system to ensure that our customers get the absolute best, most cared for, most perfect beer they can buy.
When we drafted Tim Duncan, I invited him to my home to get ready for the season.
He was learning so much.
That doesn't count, you were out.
The roses are out, Timmy, not the daisies.
So one day, you brought this into my home?
It's not something I'm proud of.
I calmly explained how Edge Pro Gel protects better than foam because it has 8 rich lubricants.
David, sure know how to make a guy feel comfortable.
More lemonade, Tim?
Edge Pro Gel. Save your skin.
Eight roses, Tim, are out of bounds.
Go with the gnomes. The gnomes can be out of bounds.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 1999 Sanford Independence Bowl is brought to you by American Airlines American Eagle. Something special in the air. And by Dodge. Do not follow. Do not conform. Be different.
Downtown Shreveport, 64 degrees at kickoff. Here's a wild look. It's Deuce McAllister. These two teams are trying to out-formation each other.
McAllister with the swing pass.
Both of these three teams trying to use a little trickery. Here you see the snap to the up back. Patrick Fletcher, he's the backup quarterback Then the wide receiver, Brandon Daniels, throws the ball. Peterson makes a great play, throws the football down. He realizes if he catches that, his team is going to have worse field position if he gets the interception. Good heads-up play by Peterson.
And a loss of four on that first down play for Ole Miss. Peterson out to the 43. Gino, another thing you see in bowl games, sometimes offenses try to get a little too cute. They have so much time to prepare. Sometimes they put a little too much in.
And that will affect a young ball club. I think you have to go back to your base offense and your base defense, especially early on. Limit the mistakes. Both these teams maybe a little bit fired up, a little bit. Their adrenaline's going a little fast right now. They need to settle down, start playing their ball game.
Third down, four. Miller, caught by Peterson, right on the stick, landed on the stick. It's got to hurt. They have broken the stick.
There you see Peterson making the key catch again.
He bent it.
We've had problems with the chain gang all game, Rich.
Look at that thing.
Take a look at Peterson. Just runs a simple hitch route. Romaro Miller throws it to the outside. That's a very accurate throw. You see Peterson fight for that extra yardage and pick up the first down.
Short of midfield. Miller, lots of time. A good strike to L.J. Taylor. Makes the catch. It's into Sooner territory. The final college football game of the century. Shreveport, Louisiana. Ole Miss and Oklahoma. Two programs that started in the late 1800s. Nine national championships combined. They have never met on the football field.
Both of these teams on the way back to their old prominence.
Movement flag. And Joe Gunn to the 33, but let's wait on the laundry. Gunn gets up limping.
Offsides by the Oklahoma defense. Joe Gunn, he's very complimentary, as we noted, to Deuce McAllister. Take a look. We can't tell, but you see Joe Gunn just explode through the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, Oklahoma was across the line when there was initial movement by the Ole Miss line.
A lot of pointing down. Did you see the movement? I didn't see the movement, if there was, but Gunn, I like his style and how he ran. He saw the crease, exploded through the line of scrimmage. That's why David Cutcliffe is so excited about these two running backs. They're very complimentary of one another.
On the 34 now. Sanford. That last exchange between Bob Stoops and the officiating crew was, hey, we saw it on the screen. I'm not sure Bob saw the angle that we saw, the second angle, Gino. The first look at that replay, you saw the movement by the left side of the Ole Miss line right before the snap. But on our second look, you saw the Oklahoma defensive lines well across the line of scrimmage.
Well, if they were drawn offsides by movement for the guard, it should have been a penalty on Ole Miss.
David Morris. In at quarterback. McAllister. Throwing it to Morris. And I think he landed in section 3B. He was looking for Kirk Kittner last night.
A smart play by Deuce McAllister. He takes the toss, turns around. It's a simple toss throwback to Morris, the quarterback. McAllister sees that Morris is covered, doesn't try to force the ball, throws it out of bounds. Never in NC2A history, Rich, has a ball ever been completed out of bounds.
You're right. Romero Miller back in, confusion on the field. Timeout will break as well. 7-3, Ole Miss.
Ah, Louisiana. Where the swamps are hopping with the sounds of Zydeco. So if you're in the mood for something different, drop by for a spell. But watch out, because your mouth is going to taste things your ears never heard of. Call 1-800-99-GUMBO today for your free 300-page Louisiana tour guide. And we'll show you how to pass a good time. Louisiana, come as you are. Leave different.
Individually, they are standouts in their respective classes. Collectively, they paint a portrait of daring and innovation. Characteristics that produce groundbreaking vehicles like Dodge Caravan. Right now, get a $329 a month lease on Grand Caravan, part of the most imitated, most trusted, and best-selling family of minivans ever. If you're ready to move in a different direction, get to the Dodge year-end event today.
Every year I say, I'm gonna quit smoking. Day later, I'm at it again. Till this year. See this? My last piece of Nicorette gum. Been smoke-free with Nicorette now for 12 weeks. With Nicorette, I help control my cravings two ways. I used it on a regular schedule to help curb them, and then for unexpected cravings, I took another piece. And now, no more craving, no more nicotine. Happy New Year.
For a better quit date, you'll have to wait another 1,000 years. You can do it. Nicorette can help.
The nation's top quarterbacks, Quincy Carter, Drew Brees, toe-to-toe in the Outback Bowl. Georgia-Purdue at 11, Saturday on ESPN.
Earlier this week on Wednesday, both teams took part in the Sharpie autograph party. It's the Samford Independence Bowl. Samford makes those Sharpie pens that are best for autographs. And making signs around the stadium as well. If you want a big sign, you've got to have a big pen. Third down, 5. Miller is back in. Miller looking, running. Right on the stick.
Miller keeps it for Ole Miss. Corey Heineke on the tackle.
Pee Wee Woods made the stop for Oklahoma.
And that's an extra dimension of Romero Miller. He has outstanding mobility. Here you see, checks 1, 2, 3, his receivers. Nowhere to go with the football. Able to use his feet to scamper for the first down.
First and 10, here's Don McPherson. Donnie?
Hey, Rich, I talked to the trainer, and he said Romero Miller did hurt his ankle on that second interception that he threw. It's limited him a little, but if you look at that last play, it doesn't seem like it's going to hamper him too much.
Down on first and 10. Little inside screen to Peterson. Gets inside. Corey Peterson to the 15-yard line. A 9-yard pickup. And the Rebels getting closer. Corey Heineke, the sophomore out of Edmond, Oklahoma.
And Ole Miss taking a wrinkle from Oklahoma's playbook. They spread the field, 4 wide receivers. A little wide receiver screen. Peterson able to make the team pick up 8 yards on that catch.
David Cutcliffe made a pretty good living with that play in Tennessee.
He had some outstanding quarterbacks and receivers that he was coaching there at Tennessee.
On 2nd and 1. Toward the end zone. Down to the 10.
No relation to Samford, Sharpie?
No, but he's very happy to come to the Samford Independent. Rocky Calmus trying to fire up that Oklahoma defense. This year, this defense allowed only 6 rushing touchdowns. gun. And there's Kalmus to make the play. Just a sophomore, Jakes High School.
114 tackles this season, Rich, and he fights off the block and makes a super tackle. He had 14 tackles for loss. He's going to be a good one in the next couple years.
Jenks High School, Tulsa, Oklahoma. 8.5 left. First half. Ole Miss on the move. Miller. Open, caught. Touchdown. Adam Bettis. That's two touchdowns now for Romero Miller.
And a nice job of recognizing coverage by Romero Miller. Oklahoma busts the coverage. They don't usually throw to their tight ends. Bettis, they come out, Bettis and Ziegler. It's a two tight end formation set. Miller looks to the left, looks off the safeties, and come back and finds Bettis for only his second touchdown catch this season.
And only his sixth catch overall, Gino.
Pretty good ratio of touchdown to catches.
Adam Bettis with the catch. And Romero Miller, who threw three touchdowns in this game last year in the upset over Texas Tech. Right now, he's got two, and Ole Miss has the lead.
As you can see, the huge New Year's Day sale and celebration is on at Moskelly's. We're celebrating New Year's Day with a bang of a sale.
Three truckloads of leather just arrived, starting at only $6.99. Look at the quality and love the 50% savings.
We've got New Year's Day specials throughout the store. Shop Moskelly's New Year's Day sale and get 12 months no interest with any purchase. Moskelly's, Airport Road, Jackson.
The swamps of Louisiana. There's only one reason why we would bring Honda ATVs to this kind of mud. This kind of terrain. This kind of non-stop torture. To see if they could get out. They're America's most popular ATVs for America's least popular places.
Come by North Jackson Honda today. Corner of Briarwood and North State Street.
On top of Oklahoma. Adam Bettis, just his sixth catch all year long.
And Ole Miss has only thrown nine balls to the tight ends. Look at this. There's no coverage on Bettis. I'm sure the Oklahoma defense and the defensive coaches felt if we see a two tight end look, we're going to take our chances and blitz and no one cover the tight end. And Miller does a good job of seeing the non-coverage and finding his tight end for a touchdown.
Carlisle McGee getting set to kick it off. Jarrell Jackson. To the 32-yard line. Coming up on ESPN Classic, you can catch the entire Sports Century countdown of the 50 greatest athletes of the 20th century. Beginning tomorrow, 7 a.m. Eastern, ESPN Classic will show every athlete, number 50 down to number one. The marathon ends on Sunday, January 2nd, 7 o'clock, with the top two athletes of the 20th century. To order ESPN Classic, 1-800-CLASSIC or call your cable provider. Josh Heupel in trouble. Still on his feet. A sliding try, but it's incomplete. Damian Mackey, the intended receiver.
Heupel does a good job of avoiding the rush. The front four of Ole Miss is getting pressure on him. He senses the pressure, able to get away out of the grass, There you see, just fighting off. He's a big, strong kid, able to have good footwork. Tries to make a nice throw on the run. That ball should have been caught for him. Damian Mackey should start making plays. These wide receivers have to start making plays for Heupel.
He slipped. The knee did not touch. And this one's caught. Savage. Antoine Savage to the Ole Miss 38-yard line. 31 yards on the completion.
We just talked about Heupel's footwork. Drops back, slips on his initial setup. The good thing I like is he stays alive and gets out inside of the pocket, able to still find his wide receiver down the field.
And 10. Bubble screen. Daniels caught from behind by Derek Burgess.
It's a fine defensive end out of Riverdale, Maryland. Rich, and I really think that last pass, it was a bubble screen to Daniels, but it looks like he was setting up to throw to one of his other receivers. Looks like it was going to be a double pass. Didn't see it open. Daniels does a good job of tucking it under and picking up some good yardage.
Remember, it was Daniels that threw the pass. It was incomplete on the fake punt.
Daniels was a quarterback last year here for Oklahoma.
Over the right side, Griffin to the 32-yard line. Armijah Spearman made the stop.
That was one thing Mark Mangino, the offensive coordinator for Oklahoma, told us. When they first arrived on campus, they had no receivers that had caught a pass last season. You go from no receivers to catching a pass to throwing the ball 35 to 50 times a game. They've stepped up big this season for them.
Five receivers with over 20 catches this year. Heupel doesn't like the look. On third and three, Griffin slips one tackle and has the first down. What a run. Quentin Griffin, the freshman out of Aldean, Texas.
Good job of audible by Heupel. He switches his running back, sees something in the front seven of Ole Miss that wasn't conducive to the play they had called. Switches the running backs.
Ball came out at the end. Scott Kempenick ended up with a football for Oklahoma. Heupel, incomplete. Chris Hammond was the intended receiver, the tight end.
With all of these different looks defensively that Ole Miss is giving Heupel as a quarterback, you have an internal clock in your head when you're throwing the football. You're dropping back, setting up in the pocket, have about two and a half seconds to make your decision and deliver the football. What all these different looks do, they throw off your sense of timing, your sense of rhythm with your wide receivers. That's why you're seeing a lot of incompletions here early in the ballgame.
Heupel through Griffin. Boy, that little kid's tough.
Pass is complete.
5'6", 186. And he's just picked up another first down. That's some effort.
It was great effort and a great job by Heupel. You see him, he gets pressure. The Ole Miss defense does a good job with their front four of pressuring Heupel. He steps up in the pocket, able to avoid the rush, finds his outlet receiver, dumps it to him, picks up some good yardage and a first down.
An impressive Oklahoma drive. Griffin inside the 10. Rice made the stop.
Quentin Griffin doesn't get a chance to run with the football that often, but he does average over 6 yards every time he runs with the football. There you see him just dodging and weaving in there and picking up. Those are big yards. Anytime you're in the red zone, anytime you can pick up 3-4 yards, that's key for your offense.
Heupel to the corner. It is picked off. Timmy Strickland.
Strickland does a great job of not allowing the receiver with inside leverage. What it forces a perfect pass by Heupel, but Strickland is right there and picks it off. There you see Heupel trying to throw the ball to the back of the end zone, underthrows it a little bit, but Strickland is right there. You see the throw. He's just throwing this to a spot, and Strickland doesn't bite it. Comes up and makes a big interception and a big turnover for the Ole Miss defense.
9 plays, 60 yards, ending in the third turnover, as you see. 4 minutes on that drive. McAllister, Deuce is loose. He will score! Touchdown, Ole Miss! 80 yards!
McAllister, a 4.28 40 time, and Coach Cutcliffe told us yesterday, if he breaks contain, there is no one that will catch him. And he showed there, nice strength through the line of scrimmage, and boy, he was moving on that run.
The extra point now. What a huge interception by Strickland. Is good. Deuce McAllister with the longest touchdown run in Independence Bowl history. And Ole Miss has raced to a 21-3 lead.
Looking to make a connection with a pen that's truly smooth? Uniball. Smooth. Real smooth.
And save him a buck or two.
He'll think you're responsible.
Yeah, excellent. Hey, which color? Smog or dirt?
Oh, you're on your own then.
1-800-COLLECT. Save a buck or two.
A pen that's smooth from start to finish. Now that's amazing. Uniball. Smooth. Real smooth.
They've played this football game, the Sanford Independence Bowl, 24 times, and that's the longest touchdown run they've seen here in Shreveport. A stunning sequence for Oklahoma. Jackson, oh my, as he popped. Flags go down, back of the 35-yard line.
That's a big turn of events for Ole Miss. The interception and then the ensuing 80-yard touchdown run by McAllister.
Jim McConaughey and his Big East crew. We're taking to the studios, Brian Kenny. Hey, Brian.
Oh, Rich, coming up on the Dodge Halftime Report, we'll check in with the bowl games of the day. Two close games and one impressive blowout. Chris Fowler, along with Lee and Kirk, will be at the Sugar Bowl with a report there, talking about Media Day with the Seminoles. And Coach John Makovic with the answer to his football riddle. We'll see you at the half, Rich.
Thanks, Brian. Nice look as everyone's getting ready for the big turning of the clock. And they had the clock on Deuce McAllister this time.
Take a look. Claxton the center. Vincent right guard. And Todd Wade, the All-American tackle on the right side. Open up a big hole for McAllister. You see great balance. There's some contact there. Knocks him off his feet. But as soon as he gets his feet back under him, there's not a soul that's going to come close to catching him. What's even more impressive, when you run with the football like that, it slows you down.
Charles Stackhouse, the fullback, also had a nice block. Tyler Williams made the stop for Ole Miss. Oklahoma has moved the football. But boy, when they've made a mistake, it's been a big one.
You know, in all of these bowl games, we've either seen mistakes in the special teams, whether it's block kicks, block punts, or turnovers by an offense. Those will make the difference in a football game. Anytime you have turnovers by an offense, usually give the advantage to the other team.
High ball on second down. In the end zone, finds Griffin. And Griffin, nice move there. Quentin Griffin. Chad Cook makes the stop. 21 yards on the catch and run.
Good job. This is just a delay route by Quentin Griffin. What Heupel's supposed to do, just takes the snap, looks downfield, invites the rush towards him, just finds Griffin. Griffin yards after the catch. There you see the nice move.
Griffin again to the 35-yard line. Tuesday on ABC Sports, the Nokia Sugar Bowl. And they'll settle it, finally. 8 Eastern, number 2, Virginia Tech. Number 1, Florida State for a national championship. Michael Vick and the Hokies trying to get their first title. Bobby Bowden and Florida State play for their third championship in school history. ABC Sports, your home of the Bowl Championship Series. Reggie Skinner on the carry. If you're counting down with us to the new year, to the new century, welcome to Shreveport, the final college football game of this century, Ole Miss and Oklahoma. An exciting ball game with 2 minutes left in this first half. Ole Miss is up 21-3, and that is a surprise. On third down, a quick throw, caught by Trent Smith, and he's out of bounds. With the first down, Don McPherson down below.
Hey, Rich, on the Oklahoma sideline, it's a combination of them being stunned and very frustrated. The coaches have pulled their teams together at different times and told them that that Ole Miss is not doing anything new, not doing anything different, and they just have to step up their intensity and step up the level of their play.
Bob Stoops knows a thing or two about intensity. 21-3 Ole Miss. Remember, Oklahoma has not been blown out all year long. All four of their losses were rather close. Heupel, it's caught by Jackson, He's dropped immediately. Ronnie Hurd made the stop.
Oklahoma is not out of this ball game. They throw the ball. They've had a lot of success throwing the football, so they can get right back in this ball game with a couple big plays. If they can get a touchdown on the board here and go down by 11 at halftime, I think they would consider that a little bit of success and try to use that as momentum for the second half.
Clock continues to roll. Sooners have a pair of timeouts left. And Heupel threw it away and got hammered. Sinecker Taylor laid the lumber on with some help from Justin Blake. At halftime, Brian Kenny and Coach John Makovic for the Dodge Halftime Report. Colorado with a big day. Bad news for Texas headed to the Cotton Bowl. And another clue in Coach Makovic's mystery. To talk about things that he will miss in this last century. David Cutcliffe's Rebels on top. Oklahoma with a big 3rd and 7. Eifert, lots of time. Still alive. And a soft throw that's caught by Jackson, who slipped. Has the first down. The clock will stop as they move the chains.
Rich Jackson has to get out of bounds and help his offense there. He tries to fight for some extra yardage. A good defensive play by Ole Miss. Stays in bounds. Now the clock's going to restart as soon as his chains are set.
Ole Miss did not have the right personnel on. They call a timeout.
But they did gain 5 seconds there because the clock stopped at 41, and I think Oklahoma saw the timeout.
And let it run. So it's at 36 right now. We'll return to Shreveport. Ole Miss on top. Oklahoma moving.
What is in a name?
Well, I tell you, there's plenty.
Aggies, there's Bearcats, Bulldogs, Boilermakers, Devils, there's Falcons, Gators, Hawkeyes, Hokies, the Mountaineers, the Owls, the Panthers, the Orangemen, the Rams, the Tigers, the Terrapins, the Vikings, the Warriors, the Yellow Jackets, and the Zip. Trust me, there's a lot in the name. NCAA football, pass it on.
Great moments in college sports make great memories and often inspire great achievement beyond the game. Come see it all at the Hall, the new NCAA Hall of Champions, a place to relive the action, savor the memories, discover what it means to be a true champion, and that might be the greatest moment sports has ever produced. The NCAA Hall of Champions, opening in downtown Indianapolis in March 2000.
If you haven't been to downtown Shreveport in a while, a lot has changed. There's a lot of building going on in this city. 36 seconds left. Out of the timeout by Ole Miss. Oklahoma has 2 timeouts left. Heupel to the sideline, and he get there? Yes. In time to stop the clock. Ole Miss thought he didn't get out of bounds.
And I think they have reason to believe it looked like his knee may have come down in the field of play. That should make the clock continue to run. Here you see Heupel just trying to get to the sidelines. No, he got there. The knee didn't come down. A good call by the official.
Good call. However, it did eat up some time on that clock. That was a 12-second play. He did a lot of running. Not yet in field goal range. Blitz coming. The throw. Caught. Jackson at the 20 to the 17. Clock stops. Oklahoma probably will use a timeout. Tim Duncan, the field goal kicker.
Rich, here's the time. I think they should just use a timeout. They have two timeouts left. They just lost 3 seconds by not calling a timeout. They have 2 left. What's the sense of going to the locker room with a timeout left?
and they lose a down.
Well, I don't think the down's very important yet. We'll see if it plays out to be important. But I think there, me as a quarterback, I would have just called a timeout, calm the offense down, especially after a big play. The offensive lineman got a run down. All those big guys getting downfield.
The Dodge halftime report coming right up. Brian Kenny, John Makovic, dressed for the evening.
Dressed very appropriately in their black tie.
I like the look tonight, gentlemen. The officials right now are discussing the play clock. And now Jim McConaughey with the ready for play, which starts the play clock. Griffin, now they'll have to burn a timeout, and it takes them a while to get it. They may put some time back on that clock, but Gino, those 3 seconds are looking pretty big right now.
Well, I think the 3 seconds, also the 4 seconds that they saw when Ole Miss was going to call a timeout, they didn't get the playoff before they called the timeout. They lost five seconds there. All these seconds are critical, especially when if they don't get out of bounds, they don't have a chance to get on the field and kick the field goal. Here with only 4 seconds left, the average play takes 6 seconds. So to me, they should probably just kick a field goal here and take the 3 points.
And it does not look like they will put any time back on the clock. So it's 4 seconds, and the Sooners are forced to settle for a shot at three.
There's no way for them, Oklahoma, to take a shot at the end zone and still have a chance to kick this field goal. That's why they have to kick the field goal here.
Every second counts is the moral of this story. Tim Duncan has missed from 35. He's hit from 34. This would be from 27. It's a fake, and Ole Miss sniffs it out. Ronnie Hurd was all over Patrick Fletcher, the backup quarterback and the holder. Ole Miss tried a fake punt. It didn't work. They try a fake field goal. That doesn't work. What a first half by the Rebels of Ole Miss.
And Ole Miss is prepared for everything. David Cutcliffe has done a great job. There you see the fake. Ole Miss did not buy it. Able to sack the quarterback. There you see. You end with no points on the board. Still down by 18. I think I'd rather kick the field goal there and at least take my chances going into halftime down 21-6.
Bob Stoops watching that and not happy with the results. 21-3, Ole Miss on top of Oklahoma. Brian Kenny, take it away.
Rich, thank you very much. Feeling festive here in Bristol. Brian Kenny and John Makovic, and the coach made that call, looking at subterfuge and trickeration, and sure enough,
trickeration didn't work.
Yes, no. SEC fans saying, this is what we're talking about. So far, that conference looking good.
Oh, I'll tell you what, how about this? Do you realize that if Mississippi wins tonight, the state of Mississippi would be 3-0 in the bowls, all three teams ranked in the top 25. Texas, California, Florida, Ohio, Pennsylvania, they won't have that likely.
We have a lot of news to talk about here on the Dodge Halftime Report. News out of Texas with the Longhorns, LeVar Arrington, and an injury update regarding Virginia Tech. Of course, Colorado State in a good one with the champions of Conference USA, and Colorado is downright scary. We're back after this.
Well, you don't know what you need to find. Why don't you come with me, little girl? What a magical ride. Well, you don't know what you need to see. Why don't you tell your friends to me? At the sea, we'll just in time for the holidays at Circuit City. Get an instant $400 toward any Circuit City purchase when you sign up for 3 years of CompuServe 2000 Premier Internet Service, only $21.95 per month. Just sign up at Circuit City, and we'll hand you a $400 merchandise card instantly, good toward anything in our store. Apply your $400 merchandise card to a computer, camcorder, big screen TV, or refrigerator. It's $400 of whatever you want, only at Circuit City.
This halftime report is presented by Dodge. Do not follow. Do not conform. Be different.
And hello, everybody. We hope you're enjoying your New Year's Eve. A busy day of college football. Start off with the Liberty Bowl. Colorado State and Southern Miss. The Rams have won five in a row going here. Co-champions of the Mountain West. As for Southern Miss, a perfect 6-0 in Conference USA, the champions of that conference. Good day for Sonny Lubick, given a five-year contract extension before he went into this one. First quarter, though, Southern Miss. The block, John Floyd with the block, 13-3, Southern Miss. Brandon Francis recovered. Now here you got fourth and inches on the one for Southern Miss. Going for a coach, and Derek Nix going in.
Great call, outside run.
Fourth quarter now. This is a tight one. Minute and change. Colorado State down 23-17. Not over yet. Matt Newton, pass in the air. No! The fourth and three won't go. Kevin McDougal ran hard, but just for 59 yards on 25 carries, coach. He lost his offensive line.
Oh, I did. Whole left side's out. Kevin McDougal, conference, or the Mountain West Conference Offensive Player of the Year. Not so good. Adelius Thomas, three sacks. He was Conference USA Defensive Player of the Year.
Southern Mississippi with a 23-17 win. How about the Insight.com Bowl? Colorado and Boston College. And what are you going to do when Ralphie the Buffalo runs over you? How about just the Buffaloes running over you? Jason Sykes picked off. Got that on Tim Hasselbeck. In he goes. 21-0 Colorado. It really wasn't close at any point in this game after the start. Ben Kelly would make it even worse. This is a tremendous talent, coach.
He's one of the really top return guys in college football. Notice how much room he has to run here. That's what allows him to get going. And then he gets a couple of blocks. He's going to outrun everybody. He's one of the fastest players in college football. He's done this a number of times.
88 yards, Ben Kelly. 35-0. Later, it's 55-14. And look at Carlton Johnson busting through. 15 carries, 201 yards on the ground, 49 of them here. And Colorado return to dominance for that man, 62-28. The guy lost his opening game to Colorado State. Nice way to finish things up.
Yeah, Boston College must have thought Ralphie was running the ball. Colorado had 51 carries, 365 yards rushing in the game.
The Pac-10 looking for its first bowl win of the season. Oregon and Minnesota in the Sun Bowl. Third quarter tied at 7. Billy Cockrum to Arlen Bruce. Golden Gophers getting 6 here. It was 6, as a matter of fact. 13-7. Extra point was no good. But fourth quarter, less than 2 minutes to go. Joey Harrington to Keenan Howry. The extra point was good. And Oregon up 24-20. Less than a minute to go. Cockrum back for Minnesota. No, look out. Knocked down. Sacked. Ducks get the ball. The Oregon guys said they're used to games like this. Now 4-1 in games decided in the last possession. The Pac-10 coach gets a win 24-20.
Yeah, a lot of dunking in college bowl games here. Joey Harrington accounted for 3 touchdowns, and the Minnesota offense just under 100 yards rushing. They have to have more than that.
Meantime, the game that we're talking about tonight, we're going to look at the SEC versus the Big Ten. The game's tomorrow. This is SEC versus the Big 12 with Ole Miss and Oklahoma. How does it size up? You know, everybody who has their favorite conference says no. Big Ten on top, SEC, Big 12 people might feel the same way.
Yeah, well, if you don't think people are keeping score out there, you're wrong. Everyone's keeping score if they're in these conferences. Who's the best? And people talk about SEC versus Big Ten, but the Big 12 wants to get in on this action too. Tonight, Mississippi, Oklahoma, not going very well for the Big Ten. But tomorrow in the Cotton Bowl, it's Texas-Arkansas, one of the great rivalries that's been put aside when Arkansas went to the SEC. And in the Fiesta Bowl, a real top-flight football game. Nebraska versus Tennessee, two big heavyweights, bring a lot to the table.
You talk about the Cotton Bowl. Things have changed a little bit. Balance of power here, maybe swinging the Cotton Bowl. Texas and Arkansas, and Texas suspending 4 players, including 2 all-conference players, defensive end Aaron Humphrey, and all-conference and all-American wide receiver Kwame Cavill. 2 very big losses for unspecified violations. Mack Brown made the announcement late last night. And LeVar Arrington, as expected, the great Penn State linebacker, and we mean great, is making himself eligible for the NFL draft. The Butkus Award winner will probably be a top three pick in the NFL draft. Mel Kiper Jr. has him in at number two behind only Peter Warrick. We're taking a break right now here on the Dodge Halftime Report. And Deuce McAllister having the huge game so far. Ole Miss up on top. We come back. Chris Lee and Kirk in New Orleans. Again, an injury to Virginia Tech. We've got that when we come back.
Individually, they are standouts in their respective classes. Collectively, they paint a portrait of daring and innovation. Traits that help create a unique vehicle like Dodge Stratus. Right now, you can enjoy the exceptionally agile handling of Stratus and save with a $1,250 cash allowance or low APR financing. If you're ready to move in a different direction, get to the Dodge year-end event today.
A significant discovery in eye health may be lutein, a nutrient found in these healthy foods. Now Centrum has the only leading multivitamins with lutein to help maintain your precious sight. Centrum, Centrum Silver, now more complete with lutein.
Planning a holiday party? Make it a very splashy event. Serve a seafood platter from Red Lobster. Shrimp, crab, or both. Either way, it's seafood worth celebrating. Order yours today.
Howdy.
Go to petstore.com to get 4 months of pet supplies free.
Back here in the Dodge Halftime, Brian Kenny and John McAvick, and it was Todd Christensen who said, you know, hearkening back to the Rat Pack, the line of the night from Todd, but now the fashion bar has been raised here at ESPN. We send it down to the Sugar Bowl right now. Chris Lee and Kirk talking about Virginia Tech and Florida State. Chris, take it away.
Well, Brian, New York has Times Square. New Orleans has its own ball above Jackson Square, and the party well underway as the folks below wait for the ball to drop, and the music is playing, and folks are wearing masks, and beverages are being consumed, and it's your typical night in New Orleans, times about 100. We are right down to the mix, and Brian, eat your heart out. You may have the scarf, but we have the bells of the ball here, guys of the feather boa. You guys have fit right into the far end of Berlin Street. I want to tell you about that. Here's one sobering thought, though, for Hokie fans. Their split end and fine punt returner, Ricky Hall, injured in practice today. He is suddenly doubtful for the game. He has a broken bone in his foot. Team doctors are trying to fix some kind of a protective device, and Hall, as senior, very much wants to play. But it does seem doubtful at this point. He's behind Davis, their second-leading receiver. That would be a blow for the Hokie offense and also for their special teams. Before practice and media day, both Beamer and Bowden addressed the historical significance of this game.
You don't really remember. And, you know, you go back over the years, and you don't remember who came in second very much. You know, you can say who won the national championship, but you don't really remember that second team very often, I don't think. So it'd be a great, great win for this program, for the state of Virginia, for our university, if we could somehow pull this thing off.
We made some minor adjustments, not a lot, you know, of trying to figure out what's the best combination to work, because all you want to do is go out there and play your best, you know. So you're trying to get your timing back, get your rhythm back without getting everybody killed. You're afraid you're going to get somebody hurt, yet you got to be prepared, you know. So have we done a better job at that? I don't know. We'll find out Saturday.
Actually, on Tuesday, Bobby, but it soon feels like a Saturday. Those players were so banged up in those practices, they said they felt like they played a game. So a different approach for the Noles this time. And your guy, Sebastian Janikowski, you see, he's enjoying himself in there most nights. Not tonight. The Noles under curfew at this moment. But most nights, he's enjoyed himself.
Well, I hope you're talking about Sebastian Janikowski, because all year I've been talking about Sebastian Janikowski, the first-team All-American place here of Florida State. I think he'll be a first-round draft pick in the National Football League. But I also want to bring up a point. Sebastian has never had to kick a field goal to win the game on the last play of the game. Now, Florida State has never done that. Virginia Tech's Shane Graham kicked the field goal that got him here against West Virginia. And as an old coach, I'm telling you, unless I've seen him done it, you never know, sweetheart. You never know.
You know, we got a little gospel, little feathered boa. We're breaking down the Sugar Bowl. Let's look at this injury to Ricky Hall, because one of the things to take, you got to take into consideration is Virginia Tech is a pro set team, which means they use predominantly two wide receivers. Not only are they going to have a little bit of a problem now with this injury, the guy to keep an eye on is going to be Emmett Johnson. He's been in. He started six games. But Andre Davis, they're both big, tall wide receivers. They're going to have to play well to obviously help young Michael Vick out, because they got a shot to try to beat Florida State deep.
Hokies also use their tight ends in key situations. Another city where they know how to throw a New Year's Eve party is down there in Miami, where Alabama and Michigan will meet in the FedEx Orange Bowl. The question is, which Tide team, which Wolverine team will show up? Because at times it looks very ordinary, but at times, Lee, both teams look like they can beat anybody.
Are we talking about Alabama?
We are. Go ahead.
Good. Okay. At the end of the football season, I think Alabama was the best football team and playing the best football in the country. And the last six quarters, they outscored Auburn and Florida 56-10. 56-10. They're confident. I think they're going to bring their A game. Did you hear me? I think they're going to bring their A game. Sounds like Alabama over Michigan
to me.
All
right, good job. All right, let me break down Alabama, because one of the reasons Alabama has improved offensively is because of the way they've implemented a little bit of play action, and also the way they've gotten Freddie Millins involved in the offense. It's a lot like Peter Warrick. They'll line him up in a shotgun at quarterback. They'll run some option with him. They'll bring him around on reverses. This is not old, bland Alabama offense. They mix it up about as well as anybody, and I like Alabama's speed. It's going to be tough for Michigan to match up with him. Trust me on that. Oh, you got a new hat.
Speaking of mixing it up, I feel a little left out here. So here's the Mardi Gras feather boa, just to complete the whole ensemble.
There.
Brian,
nice.
Coach Makovic, Happy New Year from
Happy
the Big
year.
Easy. Let's go back to the studio.
Happy New Year to you fellas as well. Chris Kirk and Lee, very live in New Orleans. Deuce McAllister and Ole Miss up 21-3 at the half. We're talking Gators and Bruce Digo's after this.
It happens once a year. S&K Menswear's winter clearance sale, with hundreds of fine quality suits like these at two for under $200. 100% wool designer suits for less than $200. Hundreds of handsome winter sport coats for $89.97. Dress shirts from $19.95. Pure silk ties for less than $15. And winter sportswear and outerwear reduced 20 to 50%. Don't miss the winter clearance sale going on now at S&K. We're America's men's store.
In Jackson at Ridgewood Court near TJ Maxx and Monroe at the Conland Mall.
Friends, when they told me I could buy a new Nissan Altima for $13,988, I almost didn't believe it. Nissan Altima, that's a $21,000 car. But not during the Millennium Countdown at Mark Escadet Nissan on the hill in South Jackson. $13,988, not $21,000. $13,988 for a brand new Nissan Altima. You won't find it anyplace else but on the hill in South Jackson, Mark Escadet Nissan.
Back here at the Dodge Halftime Report. Talk about the Citrus Bowl now. Michigan State versus Florida. Ticket sales very slow in the Mighty Gators. Now, they have feelings, too. Offensive lineman Kenyatta Walker saying, quote, "At one time, I thought our fans were the best, but I guess that's because we were just winning." Their feelings are hurt, Coach. And this one, Florida stung, getting the Spartans, though, tough team out of the Big Ten. It's the Big Ten and the SEC. We get more on this one now from Brent Musburger and Gary Danielson.
Anytime Gary Danielson at the SEC matches the Big Ten, it's just a little bit special. Those are, in the eyes of most, the two premier football conferences in the country this year. Let's start off with Michigan State. They've got Bobby Williams. He took over for Nick Saban and went to LSU, interestingly enough, of the SEC. What about Bobby's talent level?
Brent, it's good enough. Yeah, this is a team that is going to depend on three people to win this game for Michigan State. Plaxico Burress, their wide receiver, is going to have to make plays. You know, he's out there. He's going to be matched up against smaller corners. Throw the ball to him. He can do it. T.J. Duckett is the guy, though. Kind of refinish this team, a tailback that can pound. Florida has not faced anybody like him all year. But the key is going to be Bill Burke. He's been injured. We will have to see how he can throw the football.
Steve Spurrier, probably his most frustrating season ever. They played horribly in the SEC championship game against Alabama. You know what he told us? He's not going to be so emotional on the sideline. Do you believe it?
No, neither do I.
I think you're right.
He's got a young team.
Well, I know Doug Johnson would love to have that happen. Doug will play quarterback. He's had, as Steve said, a great career for him. Has not won the SEC championship. He may not be the perfect quarterback in Steve's eyes, but he does the job. I think more important than Doug, I think the Florida receivers, they need to start making some plays. When Steve sees he can throw the football, he's going to keep throwing it.
Well, we're going to have a fast track in Orlando. We could wind up with a very high-scoring Citrus Bowl.
Brent, thank you very much. And, of course, you got three matchups here between those two conferences, Purdue and Georgia on the Outback Bowl, 11 a.m. Eastern on ESPN, Michigan State, Florida, and then the Orange Bowl, Michigan and Alabama. And you see 10-5 in favor of the SEC coach over the last 10 bowl seasons.
That's right. You know what used to be the big advantage that the SEC had? And that is they always felt that they were faster than the Big Ten teams. But the Big Ten teams now throw the football. And that's a great equalizer. That's why these games are so hotly contested. That's why they're so evenly matched.
Well, by the way, bowl day comes early tomorrow. The Boas will have to go to bed early. The guys down in New Orleans. Because it will be. Chris, Lee, and Kirk, 9:30 a.m. Eastern time tomorrow morning, college game day. We'll be back after this.
My driving test kind of got off to a bad start.
On calls like this, you want to talk a while. That's why it's always a good idea to dial 1010-321.
Well, I thought I was in first.
With 1010-321, you save 50% on calls over 10 minutes. Now, that's just 8 cents a minute, day or night.
I was supposed to turn on the blinker.
And no monthly fees. And at 50% off, you can go on and on and on.
So finally, I pull out of the parking space.
Talk as long as you want with 1010-321.
Subscribers to ESPN the magazine, like Marcus Camby, really look forward to each issue.
Where's my magazine?
Get 26 issues for $1 an issue, and this fleece pullover is free. It's a warm, roomy fleece pullover with an embroidered ESPN the magazine logo.
Hey, man, it's my ESPN the magazine. Go order your own.
Call now for ESPN the magazine and free fleece pullover.
Leaders. Innovators. Champions. Where do they begin?
The University of Mississippi, where opportunities abound. To sharpen and excite the mind, to fire the imagination, and to fuel the spirit. Ole Miss, opening doors to a world of opportunity.
Dodge Halftime Report. If you've been watching all week here on Bowl Week, Coach Makovic has given clues to what he will miss most about football in the next century.
Okay, we said it involves the football and two people. Some find it funny, some find it sad. It happens every year. Both men and women identified, not just for the guys, and it always ends the same way. It's been going on for a long time, and millions of people have probably seen it because of that. And the last one is, it involves two Charlies. Okay, if you've been playing along, perhaps you know. Charles Schultz is retiring at the end of this year, and he's got a guy named Charlie Brown and Lucy, and this is what it used to look like. Lucy would hold it, Charlie would go for the kick, and ho! Not so fast, Charlie Brown. You won't be seeing that in the year 2000.
That's what you're going to miss most.
I'm going to miss it.
Throughout it all, in a metaphor for life, through football and everything else, is Charles Schultz.
I think people identified with that, and Charles Schultz was a great football fan.
Mystery solved. Coach, good working with you. Happy New Year to all of you out there. Back for the second half right after this. Enjoy.
Looking for a communications company that really cares about your business, listen to what people are saying about CDE.
90% of Greenbrook's business is phone business. We depend on our Panasonic phone system for our livelihood. We thank CDE and allowing Greenbrook to continue business.
CDE has been providing service in my three locations since 1989. The combination of Panasonic DBSs and the excellent service that CDE has provided has been great for RE/MAX.
CDE, your link to the future.
Ole Miss over Oklahoma. It's halftime in Shreveport. Rich Waltz along with Guy Lombardo. Actually, Gino Tourette.
in honor of Newfoundland. I think it just turned over there, Gino. Happy New Year in Newfoundland.
Happy New Year to you too, Rich.
It was a happy first half for Ole Miss. They played very well, didn't they?
Deuce McAllister, as good as advertised.
Yeah, I would blow it for Deuce. We'll do it later in the game. Now we're going down to Donnie McPherson. Donnie?
Okay, thanks, Rich. I'm joined now by the president of the Sanford Corporation, Paul Donahue. You have a great, great night here for the last game of the century. What are your impressions of the night and the game so far?
We got a beautiful evening. We got a sellout crowd. We got a great football game. I think everybody's a little bit surprised by the score right now, but I expect Oklahoma to come out in the second half and make a better game of it.
Now, everyone knows that you all make the Sharpie Pen Sanford Corporation. This bowl game, what has it meant for the Sanford Corporation?
Well, it gives us great exposure nationally for all of our other brands, Uniball and Accent and a number of the other great products that we make, including Sharpie. It also gets exposure out there for our company name, Sanford. And we've had a heck of a year this year, so we certainly feel that all of the sports marketing exposure has done a great job for our company.
As we come and travel to Shreveport, we see all the booming industry that's going on now in Shreveport. What are the plans for this bowl game in the Independent Stadium?
Well, the city of Shreveport and Bossier City, they are doing an awesome job of raising funds. They're going to put $20 million into this stadium next year, which we're thrilled to death to hear. It's certainly needed. They're going to put skyboxes up in the end zone. Lots of other development going around the city as well, and we're thrilled to hear it.
Paul, thanks very much, and have a great New Year.
Happy New Year.
Thanks, John. Well, it's getting closer. They're ready here in Shreveport. A lot of fans from Ole Miss, a lot of fans from Oklahoma. Didn't get to make a lot of noise in the first half.
An imperative for Oklahoma to come out and drive in this first series. Right?
Terrell Jackson. A good return out to the 27-yard line. Pictures from the first half. It was a great show for Ole Miss. Deuce McAllister and Romero Miller got off to a quick start.
Quick start, and Deuce McAllister as good as advertised. Here you see the play action fake, and Miller finding McAllister for the first touchdown. There you see Heupel. He's had three turnovers already this season. Then McAllister showing the good balance and the unbelievable speed for the long 80-yard touchdown run.
Josh Heupel and Oklahoma. Right back to the air. Terrell Jackson to the 34-yard line. Gino Toretta, numbers from the first half. What do you see?
Well, I think the big thing is Oklahoma with the three turnovers. You can't afford turnovers, especially when you throw the ball as much as Oklahoma does. Look, with only 184 passing yards, they really need to have more success and not turn the ball over anymore this second half.
Deuce trying to stay loose. Second down short. Heupel to the sidelines, and he escapes with some help. Oklahoma wanted a flag. Eddie Strong provided the push.
I think what you don't see in those numbers is the Ole Miss defense, and Art Kaufman, the defensive coordinator, has done a great job mixing up the looks that Heupel, the quarterback for Oklahoma, has seen. It's forcing him to hold the ball that little extra half of a second. And they've done an outstanding job adhering to their game plan in the first half.
Change on the way over. Bob Stoops. Just 39 years of age. It is really a family affair for the Stoops. His brother Mike is the co-defensive coordinator. He's got another brother Mark, a defensive back coach at Wyoming, who's headed to Houston. And then his other brother Ron is a high school coach in Boardman. Let's go down below. Don McPherson. Donnie?
Hey, Rich, when I talked to Bob Stoops, he said his team has to pick up their intensity. He also said they have to do a better job in the red zone scoring. On the other side, David Cutcliffe says his team has done a tremendous job in the pass game. They knew they were going to have to do some different things. He's also very happy with the way his defense has mixed things up and confused Josh Heupel.
I'll bet he is. Quentin Griffin out to the 45-yard line. That's a nice pickup for Griffin of 7 yards. Armijah Spearman and Ken Lucas, the stop for Ole Miss.
Rich, I've been very surprised at the success that Oklahoma has had running the football. Maybe it's the time the offensive coordinator, Mark Mangino, say, hey, keep the ball on the ground. Let's have a successful drive here. Get a touchdown. We need some point. Put some points on the board.
Here comes a blitz, and Heupel picks it up and delivers it quickly to Curtis Fagan for a first down.
And what Heupel didn't do in the first half, when Ole Miss brought pressure, he didn't see it early, wasn't able to find his primary receiver, and ended up either getting sacked, throwing the football away. That was a good job by Heupel, seeing the blitz and finding his open receiver.
Heupel, the jump pass, and it's dropped by Seth Luttrell. Gino, you used to throw that.
You throw all kinds of jump passes, Rich. I tell you what, though, that's a good job by Heupel. Anytime you're getting pressure, I don't care how you get it out of there. If you can deliver the football, you know, where you don't have your feet set going at your target, but you're still accurate throwing the football, that's where he steps around in there, a little jump pass, and it was an accurate throw. The ball should have been caught.
I like it. Heupel is 2 yards shy of 200 yards. Flags come raining down. Ole Miss may have had 12 guys on the field.
Timeout. On the defense. There's no flag on the play. The timeout was called prior to the flag.
They did have too many men on the field. That's why they burned the timeout. 21-3, Ole Miss.
Mark whatever you want.
Shreveport Bossier. We've got Southern hospitality, Louisiana style. Non-stop, round the clock, and red hot. Fabulous things to see. The days are spectacular, and the nights sizzle. For the time of your life, call 888-45-VISIT. Shreveport Bossier, Louisiana. America's favorite new getaway. It's a blast.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 1999 Sanford Independence Bowl is brought to you by Boise. Call Boise for office supplies, furniture, computer products, and promotional products. And by Sonic, America's drive-in.
The Texas Street Neon Bridge over the Red River. There's an awful lot of red in this stadium. 30,000 have traveled with Oklahoma. Right now, though, Ole Miss on top, 21-3. Second and 10. Blitz coming. Heupel steps in front. Completes it. A nice catch by Chris Hammonds. And he has the first down. So Oklahoma has moved the chains.
Josh Heupel's done an outstanding job of stepping up in the pocket and able to break contain and finding his second and third receiver, able to pick up completions and keep moving the chains. That's what their goal is, keep moving the chains, move it down the field. What he can't do now is once they get in the red zone, you can't keep turning the ball over.
Nine different receivers have caught balls. Daniels on a reverse, and a great move by Daniels to the 15-yard line. Sinker Taylor, the stop for Ole Miss.
Rich Daniels comes in motion across the formation. Just a little reverse handoff. He takes the handoff from Heupel, and he's got the speed to make someone miss on the outside. Now Oklahoma has to convert. They're inside the red zone. They have to pick up points here to get back into this ball game.
They have been here before. Missed field goal, a missed fake field goal, and an interception that snuffed out three drives. Griffin to the five, gain of nine. Eddie Strong made the stop.
Rick, we've talked about their inability not to score inside the red zone. Oklahoma has had a 96% scoring rate inside the red zone thus far this season. So not a normal day for them. Usually when they get down there, they're scoring.
This sea of red is just waiting to erupt. Flags. Jackson! No, did not catch it. But a flag sits back at the line of scrimmage.
Heupel saw the one-on-one coverage with Jackson. Tries to throw the fade route, almost a, what's called a fade stop.
On the defense, the penalty is half the distance to the goal. First down.
Big penalty.
Tries to throw that fade stop, but doesn't throw the ball high enough, and Jackson can't get his hands underneath the ball for a catch.
First and goal.
Maybe audible in the same play right here.
A look in. Did he get it? Jackson. No signal. Touchdown, Oklahoma.
And what Heupel sees, he sees one-on-one coverage with Jackson. They tried the fake stop. The play before wasn't successful. He says, hey, I'm going to throw the slant route. The slant's an easier throw for a quarterback to make. He throws that ball low. That's a good throw. Allows Jackson to get under, makes the touchdown catch.
Terrell Jackson, the senior out of Houston, from Josh Heupel. Oklahoma finally gets a drive to pay off.
Everybody loves Sonic's famous tater tots. But not everybody loves eating them exactly the same way. No matter how you pop them, only Sonic's got them. Come grab some with our Burger and Tot Special. A Sonic burger made the way you love it, with a load of hot and crispy tots for a special low price. Hey, how you eat them is your business. You'll love the way we do things.
Sonic America's driving.
Come on. Yes. Come on. Darn.
At ZDNet, we'll help you get more out of technology.
Let's do this.
Yes, ma'am.
ZDNet.com, where technology takes you.
Son, can I try that out?
No.
A significant discovery in eye health may be lutein, a nutrient found in these healthy foods. Now Centrum has the only leading multivitamins with lutein to help maintain your precious sight. Centrum, Centrum Silver, now more complete with lutein.
Bowl week continuing in Shreveport. Oklahoma in the end zone for the first time, barely.
Jackson showing good body control, able to get his body underneath the ball and comes up with a good touchdown catch. Now Oklahoma's defense needs to step up, and they can't allow Deuce McAllister back there returning this kick because they need a stop to get their offense back on the field.
McAllister, 4 yards deep. And the Rebels will bring it out to the 20. McAllister scored twice in the first half. The touches, 4 rushes, 3 catches, and 1 kickoff return.
And that's double his average through the regular season.
I'm surprised he hasn't touched it more. Movement and flags, and the flag came from the umpire. ESPN, National Hockey Night, 8:30 Eastern, San Jose headed into Chicago to face the Blackhawks. Owen Nolan will be there. San Jose just trailing Phoenix by 2 points for the lead in the Pacific. ESPN and ABC, your exclusive networks for all the NHL action. On first and 15, McAllister gets a touch and goes nowhere. Torrence Marshall, first to hit him. The momentum has swung a bit, Gino. The Oklahoma fans that are in this place are really jumping.
They're jumping, and what was big in that offsides penalty against Ole Miss, it puts them in a first and 15 situation. First and second down for Ole Miss's offense is critical for them to sustain key drives.
Second and 15. Miller with the blitz on him. Man open. Can't catch it. Maurice Flournoy. And Flournoy may be hurt.
Boy, when Romaro Miller watches the film, he's going to wish he had this throwback because he makes an outstanding fake. It was a hitch and go. Flournoy makes a good stop route. And Miller just not able to connect on the hitch and go. It's tough to time that route up because you're trying to gauge how far the receiver's going to be downfield. But Flournoy was wide open. But you see the defender, he bit on the fake and just threw it a little bit too far.
Miller is up and moving very well, so you suspect that he just had the wind knocked out of him.
Just barely too far to come up with the catch.
This is what the Oklahoma defense wanted. Third down and long. Miller buying time, getting to the sideline. And he escapes unharmed, but well short of the first down. Rocky Kalmus in hot pursuit.
And the Oklahoma defense stepped up. Their offense came down, had a good touchdown drive. They stepped up. Now their offense get the ball back. Rich, we talked about the fake field goal at the end of the first half, Oklahoma would only be down 8 if they make that field goal attempt right before the half.
They missed the field goal, and of course, as you noted, that fake field goal didn't work as well. Reagan King, they almost got it. In fact, they almost got King. No flag, though. And the ball lands right around midfield. Outstanding start for Oklahoma to this second half. Down below, Don McPherson and a special guest, Donnie.
Hey, Rich, very special indeed. I'm joined now by Ken Heupel, the dad of Josh Heupel, and also a coach at Northern State.
Yes, in South Dakota.
That's right, in Aberdeen, right. South Dakota. That's
we
right.
You got that right.
Coach, so far, the performance of your son, what do you think so far?
Well, I thought, you know, the first half, they really came out slow and really rusty looking. They were in the red zone 5 times and didn't get any scores. I thought that was crucial. Coming out the second half and taking it down and scoring, I thought was really big, and hopefully they can take the ball here again and get it done.
You obviously talk like a coach. How difficult is it to watch this game as a coach and as a father watching your son?
It's very difficult. You know, the emotions run deep, and, you know, we had a lot of answers up there at halftime. But, it, you know, I'm glad to be here with the family and watching Josh play. They're playing, I think, the style of ball now that they're used to, and it should be a great game.
Coach, because you coach, you don't get a chance to see him. This is only your 4th time seeing him this year or seeing him ever in college. What's it like to see him live?
It's exciting. Anytime you can see your son or your daughter performing and that type of thing, it's exciting. And I'm just glad to be here and watching Josh in a great atmosphere. And hopefully they'll come back and win this ball game.
Ken, the whole family's down here. Have a great holiday.
Thank you very much.
It's been some journey for Heupel. Aberdeen, South Dakota, Weber State University, Snow Junior College, and then Oklahoma. He's in Shreveport, facing 2nd and 4. Here comes a blitz. Heupel's throw is low and outside for ball 2. Third down.
This throw's a little low by Heupel, but his tight end, Trent Smith, has to come up with this catch. Anytime there's a blitz, the receivers can't expect the quarterback to throw the ball perfect and be right on the money every time. It's not like he's just sitting back there and doesn't have any pressure.
Oklahoma did not face a third down on that last 73-yard drive. They get one here, 3rd and 4. Heupel. He walked into a sack and goes down. A great effort by the Ole Miss defensive secondary.
A great effort by the Ole Miss defensive secondary. But I don't think we can give enough credit to Coach Kaufman, the defensive coordinator for Ole Miss. I'm watching that play, and I see all-out pressure. Ole Miss, at the snap of the ball, they come out. They do not blitz. Oklahoma and Heupel not sure where to go with the ball. And there you see the father's reaction. So tough to watch your son.
I think that was the coach's reaction and the father's reaction. Jeff Ferguson to punt it. And he popped that one up. Ouch. Not a good one at all. They will mark it at the 48-yard line. That's a 7-yard effort. And Bob Stoops is letting him know about it. Next week on ESPN, the PGA Tour starts its 2000 season with the Mercedes Championship. Live from the Plantation Course at Kapalua. Tiger Woods won 8 tour events last year. He'll try to get a head start on this year. First round coverage begins Thursday at 7 Eastern on ESPN. For more, log on to ESPN.com. Part of the Go Network, go.com. Ole Miss, they're on 45. Miller. At the 32, Ryan Fisher.
And the Oklahoma defense comes right back out and returns the favor to Ole Miss, brings the blitz, and able to get to Miller with the sack. Miller sees the blitz. There was actually pretty good protection by his offensive line. The running backs picked up the linebackers, but you don't have all day. If your first read isn't there, when you see a blitz like that, you have to just throw the football away.
Second and 20. Flournoy is back in the game and in motion. Miller was looking for him and finds him. He lost the ball. Ole Miss gets it back. Tuton Reyes recovered a loss of three more.
And Ole Miss is doing exactly what Coach Cutcliffe did not want to do, getting third and long situations. Here you see Miller just drops back. No one's open, finds his receiver late. And there you see the big hit. Able to knock the football out. Fortunately for Ole Miss, the offensive lineman, Tuton Reyes, came over and recovered the fumble.
Michael Thompson, the freshman out of Bristow, Oklahoma, made the hit. Miller's throw is incomplete.
And now the Oklahoma defense has really started to step up their game, and hopefully that can carry over to their offense. Like I said the last time, the Oklahoma offense needs to start putting points on the board.
Two times now, the Oklahoma defense has had third and long. And remember, Reagan King's last punt was almost blocked. This one is away. Jackson. Whoa! Jarrell Jackson is caught and dropped. Sheldon Morris on the special team. We've got a good one. The SEC and the Big 12. Ole Miss and Oklahoma.
You know, here at LeadCo, we like to eliminate problems like this problem right here. Now look at the after shot of how we wipe away those painting chores. Call LeadCo right now, 1-800-530-7665. Maybe you need new windows. Look at this before shot and now the after shot, the tilt-in type. You'll love them. Call in right now. LeadCo is looking for 30 display homes to install their Designer Series siding and windows. Special discounts will be offered for display and advertising purposes. Don't you miss out. Call LeadCo right now.
Hello, I'm Don Evans. If you've been seriously injured in an automobile accident as a result of someone else's negligence, you need an experienced trial lawyer to handle your case.
You may be faced with large medical bills or even long-term disability, but you may be entitled to full compensation for all of this. Just call me. It costs nothing to discuss your case with me. There are no fees or expenses unless I collect for you. If you're in the hospital or unable to come to me, I'd be glad to come to you.
Oklahoma is on the move. We're building the largest university-based natural history museum in the world. And with students from over 100 countries, we're creating an international study center to prepare our students to live and work in the global community. OU ranks number one in the nation per capita of all public universities and the number of National Merit Scholars on our campus. Watch us. You'll be hearing a lot more about the University of Oklahoma.
Big part of any bowl game, a visit here in Shreveport by the Oklahoma players to the Shriners Children's Hospital. Bob Stoops and his players, very happy to do it. You know, you did a little bit of that when you played the Shrine game out in Palo Alto as well.
And a wonderful experience, probably greater for the players to see just how fortunate you are when you go to the Shriners Hospital visit.
First and 10, Oklahoma. Heupel. Jackson to the 28. Tim Strickland made the shot.
This is complete, Israel Jackson.
The Oklahoma defense, the Ole Miss defense has really come out, and they're trying to hit, and they're hitting hard, these Oklahoma wide receivers.
6:43 left. We're in the third. There's Art Kaufman, fifth year at Ole Miss. When Tommy Tuberville went to Auburn, he took literally his whole staff except Kaufman. And when David Cutcliffe got here, he embraced Kaufman. And with good reason. He's an outstanding defensive coordinator. Right on the money is Heupel. Right on the numbers to Brandon Daniel. 9 yards and a first down for Oklahoma. The 24th Sanford Independence Bowl. Ole Miss, Oklahoma. The final college football game of the century. And it's been a good one from a sold-out Independence Stadium in Shreveport. A 21-3 halftime lead by Ole Miss. Oklahoma scored on their first possession of this half. And they continue to move the football. Heupel's throw, Jackson the catch. Across the 40 to the 42.
And Art Kaufman really has this defense swarming. There you see just a wide receiver screen. The tackle is actually made by the defensive end. That's a great job. He didn't get pressure on Heupel, turns around and runs the receiver down.
Second down. Heupel. Oh, big hit. Savage holds on. Sinecker Taylor there to greet him. But Antoine Savage. And a great catch.
And Art Kaufman, the defensive coordinator for Ole Miss, was very concerned with all the packages that Oklahoma runs, the different formations of motion. You see Heupel just stepping up in the pocket, able to find Savage. That's a great job of holding onto the football because that contact by Taylor is right when the ball gets there.
Heupel beats the blitz with a quick throw to Savage. Three straight completions to Savage. And he's very close to a first down. And the Sooner Express is back on its rail.
Three straight completions by Heupel, and that is the greatest deterrent to a blitz. If you as a quarterback can make some completions, they turn out to be big plays. It forces the defense to come back, play zone coverage, and they'd rather not give up those big plays.
Gonna throw deep, man open, caught for a touchdown. Brandon Daniels. Oklahoma will go for two.
A great job by Josh Heupel buying time for his receivers to get open, and Daniels able to slip behind everybody in the secondary, and Heupel delivers a nice touchdown pass.
The extra point team went out on the field. Heupel was still out there, and he looked at the sideline to head coach Bob Stoops, who wants the timeout and wants to talk about this opportunity, whether to go for two or take the point.
And the question is, they go for two and get it, you're only down by three. Here you see the eyes of Josh Heupel. Takes the shotgun snap. No one's open. He senses the pressure by the Ole Miss defense. Able to stay alive. Still keeps alive with his eyes downfield. And finds Daniel behind everybody. He's wide open. Makes the catch right at the one, goes in for the score. Here you see, he's buying time and sees Daniel. That's an outstanding job by Heupel because it's very tough when you're moving your feet and running around in that pocket to keep your eyes downfield. And there you see the reaction.
Who says you have to throw a perfect spiral?
That was perfect. It goes down in the book, one for one, and a touchdown. My book.
In the book, he was 6 of 6 on that drive, 80 yards.
And now let's see what the Ole Miss defense does, because the reaction is when you get burned on the blitz, then you end up tending to come out of the blitz and not pressure.
It's interference, and obviously Oklahoma would decline it. The two-point conversion looks to be good. And there's an Ole Miss player down.
And a great throw and catch by Heupel to Hammonds. Hammonds makes a tough grab because he gets hit as soon as the ball gets there, maybe even a little bit before the ball gets there, and that's what we think the apparent flag is.
Interference on the defense. The penalty is declined. The points are good.
The junior out of Sulphur, Oklahoma, Chris Hammonds.
See, Heupel take the shotgun snap. It's a corner route by Hammonds. Heupel throws this ball before Hammonds even makes the cut. There you see just a super catch by Hammonds for the two-point conversion. Ball's in the air way before Hammonds makes that cut. There you see Stoops. He knows when they get the 2 point, now they're only down by 3. A field goal ties it. As coaches, you're always thinking one chess move ahead.
Tim Duncan, the kicker. It's a three-point ball game, 21-3 at halftime. Deuce McAllister, Seneca Taylor, deep. McAllister. Out of bounds at the 18-yard line. It's been 5 years since Oklahoma went to a bowl game, the turnaround occurring this year. And this year, the Sooners finished at 5-3 in a very good Big 12 conference.
Coach Stoops and the rest of his staff have done a great job of getting the young players on Oklahoma roster to buy in, said, hey, we want to win now. We're not here for a five-year program. We want to win now and continue winning after this season.
Let's see what Ole Miss does on first down on this drive. Deuce McAllister for the 20, gain of 2.
Rich, with this comeback by Oklahoma, what it does is it brings this crowd back into the ball game, because this is like home field advantage for Oklahoma, because they have about 70% of this stadium is Oklahoma fans.
Romero Miller, a pair of touchdown passes in the first half. McAllister to the 24-yard line. Third down and 4, Don McPherson.
Well, Gino, you're exactly right. The crowd noise really does affect what happens on the field, and you can feel it down here. I'm behind the Ole Miss bench, and it's very quiet on the bench. Again, they have more than 130 players on the bench. That's 130 people not making a lot of noise, because Oklahoma's doing a great job coming back.
Carry enough for the first down towards Sanford. the defense of Oklahoma, coordinated by two men. That's Brent Venables, who was a great linebacker at Kansas State. His defensive coordinator when he was there, Bob Stoops. The other defensive coordinator is Mike Stoops, who was an All-American in Iowa. Mike Stoops is upstairs. Brent Venables, obviously downstairs. First down goes Miller. Marshall.
Stoops and Venables told us Torrance Marshall and Kalmus are great blitzers and linebackers. There you see. He'll come out of the right-hand side of your screen. They run motion. Ole Miss offense doesn't adjust, and Miller does not see the blitz coming from his blind side. That's a big play because first and second down are key for the Ole Miss offense.
Second and 16. Joe Gunn out to the 30. That was the original line of scrimmage. And it's a third down and 10. This game has really turned from first to second half.
And it's turned on the arm of Josh Heupel. He's had some success. Look at that. Negative yards for Ole Miss and 148 for Oklahoma. And all on the arm of Josh Heupel. He's had the opportunity. He's completed some passes, made some big plays, breaking contain, getting out of the pocket.
Blitz coming. Caught. Jamie Armstrong right on the stick. Michael Thompson on the coverage. With the spot, it looks like an Ole Miss first down.
And Ole Miss max protects. They did not want to get burned by the blitz again. Miller steps in the pocket, knows he's got everybody blocked. A good, accurate throw. And there you see Armstrong making sure of the catch and going down with the ball, picking up the first down.
Final seconds, third quarter. Play clock, not on the game clock. Romero Miller and Ole Miss will have first and 10 when we get back. The Sooners and the Rebels. Josh Heupel has Oklahoma right back in it.
A pen that's smooth from start to finish. Now that's amazing. Uniball. Smooth. Real smooth. As America's first choice in beer during the past century, Budweiser invites you to ring in the new millennium with the clean, crisp taste you've always enjoyed. We raise a toast to the new millennium. Tonight, as always, this Bud's for you.
Join Club Ramada now, and every cool dip in our pool, every chill drink on our menu, every cozy night in our rooms will be even more rewarding. Club Ramada is free to join, and every dollar you spend will take you closer to great rewards like free nights, free flights, and free fun stuff for the whole family. Join Club Ramada, and earning great rewards will be easier than ever. For reservations, call 1-800-2-RAMADA or at ramada.com on the internet.
Here's the defense you'll be facing Sunday.
Hey, that's Terrell's mom.
Hey, it's Terrell. He's eating chunky soup.
Hi, baby. You always love that chunky chicken noodle.
Well, now it's harder than ever to fill you up right with big chunks of chicken and veggies and bigger noodles.
Oh, man.
This is a trading film.
Campbell's Chunky Chicken Noodle.
It's better than ever.
I'm freezing my
ass off. There's the lodge.
I'll make him turn.
Wait a minute. The angle's too sharp.
Don't be a wimp. I know what I'm doing. Trade!
Nice job. Now we're going to have to call his parents.
We'll use 1-800-COLLECT. Save him a buck or two.
1-800-COLLECT. Now you're being logical.
Poor baby.
Aww. Nice cast.
Hi, Mom.
Use your head.
1-800-COLLECT.
Save a buck or two.
Or three.
Looking to make a connection with a pen that's truly smooth? Uniball. Smooth. Real smooth.
Mike Stoops on the right, Brent Venables on the left, co-defensive coordinator, talking with each other, trying to stop Ole Miss. Rebels keep it on the ground, up to the 44-yard line. Deuce McAllister, the ball carrier. Our Beck storyline of the final college football game of this century. Deuce McAllister was the star in the first half. An 80-yard touchdown run, a touchdown catch. But Josh Heupel of Oklahoma has brought the Sooners back in the second half. Look at the yards by half. Miller. Caught by Adam Bettis, the tight end. Roy Williams on the coverage. Bettis had a 9-yard touchdown pass from Miller. Ole Miss built a 21-3 lead at the half.
And I think one thing they should go back to, Rich, you have to get the ball to Deuce McAllister. Had a lot of success in the first half. They really haven't had a chance to let him try to make a big play.
David Cutcliffe told us not only is he a great running back, he's one of our best receivers. That's a gorgeous throw. Out at the 30-yard line. Mike Woods on the coverage. Miller showing some arm.
But what sets it up is the play-action fake to McAllister. The Oklahoma defense sucks up. Miller gives Miller time to throw this pass. And Peterson on the out route. There you see Miller's got all day to throw. Knows a nice spiral on the out cut. Peterson picks up the big yardage.
Can you hear me?
19 yards on the pickup. Miller's had a good day. Uh-oh. McAllister gets back to the line of scrimmage.
That was probably McAllister's best run of the day, even though just to get back to the line of scrimmage, it looked like there was a miscommunication. Either Miller came out or McAllister went to the wrong side. Did a nice job to get back to the line of scrimmage and make it second and 10.
Of time. Tumbling, Jamie Armstrong cannot make the catch. And there's a flag down back at the 34. Ball might have been tipped as well.
The ball was tipped, but usually where that flag comes in, when you have that much time to throw, there could be a holding penalty on the offensive line.
Romero Miller begs to disagree.
And I could be wrong.
That's a 15-yard face mask.
Wow, instead of third and 10, that gives Ole Miss a first down, and it continues to move the chains down the field.
Les Pinkley, the field goal kicker.
Personal foul, grabbing the face mask on the defense.
See a look at Stoops. Very disappointed because the defense held, But with the face mask, it continues to drive, gives offense Ole Miss 15 yards. There's the face mask by the defensive lineman, Ryan Fisher.
McAllister to the 14. Torrance Marshall made the stop.
Rich, and with 12 minutes left, time really isn't a factor with the way Oklahoma throws the football, because they have a chance to stop the clock, throw the football, get some outcuts, get some passes completed at the sideline. So time isn't a factor yet.
It's hard to believe that on New Year's Eve. It will be soon, though, Gino. In both cases, Miller. The catch is by Jamie Armstrong. That will not help his yak yards. The yardage after catch.
And I tell you what, right as Romaro Miller threw that football, he threw it and realized he probably could have run for about 15 yards up the middle, maybe had a chance of getting in the end zone.
And now it's third and seven. Miller throws it away. Pressure by Roger Steffen, the junior out of El Reno, Oklahoma. David Cutcliffe is not a happy coach.
And Oklahoma defense did a great job of adjusting. They bend, but they didn't break. And now let's see if Ole Miss can convert with the field goal.
Les Binkley with his first attempt. He was 14 of 16 this year, 29 yards. It's away and it's good. David Cutcliffe still steaming, but Ole Miss adds three, 24-18. Les Binkley from 29 out.
Out here, the stories unfold like a map. Stories written across the sky with the tip of an eagle's wing. Stories to fill a scrapbook you'd want to page through again and again. But first, you've got to go to where the stories live. You'll need an outfitter for the journey. Ford is your outfitter. With the most far-reaching sport utilities on Earth, created to take you where the stories begin and never end. Ford Outfitters. No boundaries.
Yeah.
There's something about a Wendy's classic double with cheese.
I'd have made the same choice.
But it's hamburger bliss. Mm-hmm.
Save at Circuit City's New Year's sale with hundreds of markdowns throughout the store. All TVs 32 inches and larger, camcorders and appliances are on sale. All home audio loudspeakers, car audio, and mini systems are on sale too. Our knowledgeable sales counselors can answer all your questions and help you find just what you're looking for. Save throughout the store at Circuit City's New Year's sale.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 1999 Sanford Independence Bowl is presented by Uniball Pens from Sanford. Smooth, real smooth, and in part by Ford Outfitters. No boundaries.
Quite a show on New Year's Eve by Oklahoma and Ole Miss. along with producer Brian Carter, director John DelVecchio, Rich Waltz, Gino Toretta, Don McPherson, Bob Stoops. His Sooners down big at the half. Jarrell Jackson awaits. To the 37-yard line. Jarrell Jackson with a nice return.
Jarrell Jackson with a return.
Earlier tonight, a gentleman named Donald Weaver out of Freeport, New York, hit a field goal for $25,000. The Boise Cascade Foundation not only gave Weaver $25,000, they donated $25,000 to the Susan Pullman Breast Cancer Fund. Boise Cascade, a big sponsor of the Independence Bowl. That's a pressure kick, Gino. Of course, he had 2 minutes, and he missed about six of them. Griffin. Now to the 35-yard line.
Why do you have to steal the thunder, Rich?
I know.
Come on.
I know.
The guy kicked the field goal.
Hey, he's got $25,000. He's a happy guy.
He's taking us out tonight, right?
I would hope so. Ole Miss early. In fact, Deuce McAllister with a couple of touchdowns. Then Oklahoma stormed back in the third. Missed opportunities for the Sooners in the first half. Josh Heupel. Down six. Inside shovel. It goes as a pass. And Daniels, who was a quarterback last year, as a first-team Big 12 receiver this year. 2 years ago, Gino, he was the strong safety. Last year, he played quarterback. This year, he makes the move to wide receiver and he's first team all conference.
He's done a great job converting. 50 catches, 3 touchdowns is already this season.
On third and short, Heupel straight ahead. First down.
You mentioned that little flip pass. That counts as a pass and a completion. Those are the best for a quarterback. Throw him 2 yards and your receiver picks up 10 or 12.
Heupel's pass caught by Savage. Savage inside Ole Miss territory. To the 39, it's a gain of 14.
It's a gain of 14. Credit Savage with making some defenders from Ole Miss miss the tackles because Heupel throws this pass about 4 or 5 yards downfield on a little stop route, little slant. There you see Savage make the defenders miss and pick up the first down.
Comes a blitz. Heupel on the money. Jarrell Jackson. Very close to a first down.
Heupel's really done a great job sitting in the face of pressure and delivering the passes. Here you see Jackson goes up on a curl route and Heupel able to stand in that pressure and deliver the strike to Jarrell Jackson for another first down. Or excuse me, second and one.
Second and one for Oklahoma.
Independence Bowl record and an Oklahoma Bowl record now with 34 completions. A big sack because second and one just became third down and six.
Besides third down at six, Rich, that sack all but takes you out of field goal range. So now Oklahoma has to pick up the first down. A great job by Shaney Lump of getting pressure and getting the Heupel for the sack.
Art Kaufman's defense trying to hold on. Heupel, Daniels, he's got the first down to the 24-yard line. Chad Cook made the stop. Heupel continues to click.
These little short passes, this is like Oklahoma's running game. The short passes account for the running game. I know it goes as passing yardage, but this is just a little inside slant route. Heupel sees it off the snap of the ball, delivers a nice pass, picks up the first down.
Heupel has hit 10 in a row now. 11 in a row. Savage fights his way to the 19. It's a gain of five. Coming up after this one, Carl Ravitch, Bill Pito, and SportsCenter. Complete bowl wrap-up of all the games today. Scores, highlights, Brett Hull going for his 600th. Now the question of the night, sports moment of the century. At SportsCenter, coming up following Sanford Independence Bowl, the last college football game this century. And it's a good one. Heupel. Hit. Lost the ball. Was it a throw or a fumble? It's a fumble and Ole Miss has it. How about that?
What a job by the Ole Miss defense. Art Kaufman stays with his idea. He wants to pressure Heupel. Heupel sees the blitz. The protection of Oklahoma does not pick it up. Heupel, I think, tried to do a little bit too much here. Just take the sack. He almost tried to do that little jump pass like he did on the first half. And Anthony Sims able to force the turnover. There you see the blitz by Taylor. Doesn't sack Heupel, but forces him to make that bad decision and try to throw the football.
Ole Miss on the ground now. McAllister to the 20-yard line.
Ole Miss has to sustain a drive here, Rich. If they can do that, they'll take a lot of time off the clock and force Oklahoma into a two-minute situation when they get the ball back.
Or Oklahoma turnover. Heupel will get another shot. McAllister. Whoa, look at that. The knee hit and McAllister is down. I don't know about that.
What balance by McAllister. Even if the knee did hit, for him not to go down was unbelievable. There you see, just takes the draw fake. Getting upfield. There you see the hit. Whoa, his knee didn't even hit. Rich, he might be still running if they don't call him down here. There you see, he slips and falls.
Oh, it did. Oh, it did, Gino. Great call by the official.
Good officiating call. That's why I'm not wearing the stripes today, Rich.
That was a fine rebound, Gino. And a good call by this Big East crew. The McAllister to the 32. And we had to look at it twice in slow motion. They got it right the first time in real time.
They're a little bit closer to the field than us.
Five and a half minutes left. Ball game. Ole Miss on top throughout this game.
A will say, though, Ole Miss is that close with a big play by McAllister to put the nail in the coffin. The knee hits this time at the 34-yard line.
McAllister, the ball carrier.
Rocky Kalmus made the stop.
And Rocky Kalmus on the tackle for Oklahoma.
What I'd like to see here, Rich, is a third medium situation for Ole Miss. I'd like to see him throw the ball to McAllister out of the backfield.
Deuce at the top of your screen. Miller picked off and dropped. Torrance Marshall, the junior, who has played a tremendous game tonight.
Played a tremendous game. The Big 12 defensive newcomer of the year. 7 sacks. Miller just tries to force this ball, and Torrance Marshall makes a nice break on it. Those are good instincts for a linebacker, but you know what they say, Rich. That's why he's playing linebacker and not fullback.
Or tight end. But he's a good one. Reagan King has had a couple near misses. This one away cleanly. Not a long one, but a great bounce. If you're a Rebel. At the 21, Oklahoma will try to put it in and come back.
A pen that's smooth from start to finish. Now that's amazing. Uniball. Smooth. Real smooth.
Imagine living life on a grander scale. Imagine tasting water when it's brand new. Or being one with nature without going it alone. Introducing Ford Excursion. Discover the ultimate in capability. From Ford Outfitters. Offering you the most far-reaching sport utilities on Earth. Ford Outfitters. No boundaries.
A significant discovery in eye health may be lutein, a nutrient found in these healthy foods. Now Centrum has the only leading multivitamins with lutein to help maintain your precious sight. Centrum, Centrum Silver, now more complete with lutein.
We didn't invent the idea of handpicking 20 exceptional stocks for a powerful fund, but we have practically perfected it. Call 1-888-4-STRONG today. You're one call away from a strong portfolio.
Looking to make a connection with a pen that's truly smooth? Uniball. Smooth. Real smooth.
The nation's top quarterbacks, Quincy Carter, Drew Brees, toe-to-toe in the Outback Bowl. Georgia-Purdue at 11, Saturday on ESPN.
20 minutes from New Year's in the East. After the game, SportsCenter will be in full force. Defense for Ole Miss has been here all night.
They've been outstanding. Forced four turnovers already. Here you see the first fumble. They had 3 turnovers in the first half. There you see the fumbled exchange between the center and quarterback. And then Heupel tried to force the ball. McAllister coming up with a big interception. And there was the last. The attempt at a jump pass. And Heupel fumbles the ball.
This youngster trying to hold out for the celebration. Both the Oklahoma celebration and the one after that. Josh Heupel with the chance to wake him up. I'm not sure who that was going to, and that may be interference. Brandon Daniels, or it may be an ineligible receiver. Let's see. Eddie Strong was hooked up with Brandon Daniels. Ineligible receiver.
Hello.
ball downfield on the offense. 5-yard penalty from the line of scrimmage to keep it down.
It has been an outstanding Circuit City Bowl week, and it concludes tomorrow on ESPN, 11 a.m. Eastern, the 2000 Outback Bowl. Drew Brees and Purdue against the Georgia Bulldogs. Georgia looking for their second Out Bowl back win in 3 years. It all begins at 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific with Bowl Game Day. Josh Heupel now. Incomplete. Second down and long.
And Rich, the illegal offensive lineman downfield. It was a good job. Ole Miss forced Heupel to hold on to the ball, and what it was attempt at is a wide receiver screen. As soon as the snap, those offensive linemen are going downfield. They're on a one count, and they're going down to try to block for the receiver. That extra half a second he held the ball. That's what the penalty was.
Heupel. Caught by Daniels. Almost gets loose. Down at the 28-yard line. Short of the first down. Third down and a long three, maybe four.
See Heupel. Take the shotgun snap, finding Daniels in the flat area. Daniels able to make a big play, gets upfield with yards after the catch. Now it's a makeable situation, puts him in a third and medium instead of a third and long.
Flags down, Heupel goes down, and this may be against Ole Miss. They may have moved early. Seneca Taylor, a big hit on Josh Heupel.
Unfortunate for the Ole Miss defense, because I think this is going to be encroachment on the defense.
Offside on the defense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Because Taylor, here you see Taylor creep up late on the blitz. Heupel does not see him, and Seneca Taylor just delivers a blow to Josh Heupel.
And a heads-up job by the senior center, Matt O'Neill. O'Neill snapped the ball once he saw the defense across the line of scrimmage. First and 10 now. Griffin. There goes Griffin. And he's out of bounds at the 43. 24 yards for Quentin Griffin.
Rich, we said earlier, Quentin Griffin doesn't get a chance that often to run with the football. Averages over 6.5 yards a carry. And here he shows some fleet of foot, and he's very nimble and very fast. Able, good cutback, nice vision there in the hole. Oklahoma needs to keep continuing those big plays to keep these chains moving on this drive, because now time is a factor with less than 4 minutes to go in this ballgame.
Two timeouts apiece as we're under 4 minutes. Shovel pass. Griffin again to the 38. It's a gain of about four. Clock will roll. Armijah Spearman made the stop.
Where most conventional offenses, they'll drop back and just hand it to the running back as a draw. That serves as Oklahoma's draw. The little shovel pass. Quentin Griffin just tries to hide up in the inside the line of scrimmage. And Heupel just with the little shovel pass.
Here comes the blitz. Heupel gets it off. Daniels. He's dragged down at the 17-yard line. First and 10, Oklahoma.
Rich, I'm sure Heupel people is finding Brandon Daniels, because as a former quarterback, Daniels can recognize when there's going to be blitz pressure. Heupel sees the pressure, and I'm sure Daniels does. Makes a quick move inside, able to make another big play. I'm sure Heupel realizes, you know, just how important Daniels' experience at quarterback is to him as his wide receiver.
Heupel doesn't like what he sees and calls a timeout. The play clock was running down. 24-18. The Sooners on the move.
Hello. This is Mark John Jeffries for a PPPC. A friend just emailed me that there was a grave oversight in my last chat with you. Well, I told you how you could get a really terrific brand name PC like this one. Plus, unlimited internet access, in-home service, and great deals. All for just $24.95 a month. I did not say out loud how easy it is to get in touch with PeoplePC, but I could fix that right now. Visit us at PeoplePC.com or just dial 1-800-PeoplePC. Simple. While you get something to write with, let me go over the plan one more time. Let's review. For about the price of internet service alone, you get the whole pie over here. A new computer, in-home service, deals, and unlimited internet access. Visit us at peoplepc.com or call us. Thank you for letting me set the record straight.
Who's the biggest college basketball fan from outer space?
Oh, Hulik's be me name.
He's hip, he's cool, and he can only be found on Hoops Malone.
Come strong or don't come at all, me boy.
Hoops Malone is brought to you by College Hoops on ESPN.
Coming up on SportsCenter after the Independence Bowl, 1999 comes to a conclusion with four bowl games. Brett Hull goes for his 600th goal and the best of the NBA from the 20th century. Join me, Bill Pito, along with Carl Ravitch for the year 2000 on SportsCenter.
Downtown Shreveport, not a lot going on there. Maybe. We're not done here yet. Inside Independence Stadium, a sellout. Heupel scrambling, looking, throwing. Griffin, touchdown, Oklahoma!
Made the big plays for Oklahoma's offense when he stepped out of the pocket. He feels the pressure, able to break contain, still keeps his eyes downfield, and able to find Griffin in the back of the end zone.
A very large extra point for a sophomore out of Clinton, Oklahoma, Tim Duncan. It's blocked, and it gets through.
Things bounce your way, they bounce your way. And that ball was a big bounce for Oklahoma.
Oklahoma with their very first lead of the night. Barely. Following Quentin Griffin, Tim Duncan sneaks it through. 25-24 Oklahoma.
In my house, I have a stair climber. In my house.
I have a stationary bike.
In my house,
I have a treadmill.
In my house,
a rowing machine.
And they're all collecting dust.
Get out there and explore from your Ford Outfitter. Outfitting you with the most far-reaching sport utilities on Earth. Ford Outfitters, no boundaries.
You want to come up here? You want to come up here? Come on. Come on. You want to come up here? You want to come up here? Up! Come on. Come to Daddy. You want to come up? Come on. You want to come up here? Up. 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 Come on, Petey.
Howdy.
Oklahoma 25, Ole Miss 24. A madhouse at Independence Stadium.
I'm sure most of these fans did not think they were going to wait till 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter to have a lead in this football game.
Deuce McAllister, who is capable of taking it back, is deep. McAllister from the two. McAllister. Deuce. McAllister is all the way out to the 45-yard line. He is something.
He is something. McAllister is something. Let's take a look. There you see Heupel able to keep his eyes downfield, break contain, but keep his eyes downfield and find Griffin in the back of the end zone. Griffin does a great job once he makes the catch of keeping his feet inside the field of play for the touchdown. There you see after the throw, he knows once that catch, they're going to have the lead with the extra point.
The focus shifts now to the Rebels. Ole Miss, their own 42. Romero Miller, the junior quarterback. McAllister, an inside handoff, and Deuce McAllister reaches across midfield. Very close to the first down. He's short by a yard. The Rebels have to hurry.
Rich, I don't think there's any doubt who Ole Miss is going to go to. They're going to go to McAllister early and often on this drive.
And remember, all Mississippi needs is field goal range. They have two timeouts. And they have Deuce McAllister, who breaks another one. A flag is down at the line of scrimmage. That could be a huge penalty. Ole Miss will decline it. The Rebels have to be careful, though, Gino, because the clock's going to start on ready for play.
The clock's going to start with
offside on the defense. The penalty is declined.
What's been very impressive is the power that McAllister has shown as a running back on this last drive. He's already showed us his speed. Now he's showing us his power.
Very close to field goal range. Miller throwing. Incomplete. Jamie Armstrong, the intended receiver, second and 10.
And if Armstrong comes up with that catch, Rich, that puts them in field goal range, albeit a long field goal.
Second and 10 for Ole Miss.
25-24. Oklahoma. Ole Miss with a pair of timeouts. On second and 10. Miller, lots of time. And a man, it's caught. L.J. Taylor. Clock continues to roll. Ole Miss will burn a timeout. And this is going to be a very interesting third down. Miller on his way to the sidelines. Les Binkley getting ready. Stick around.
I'm just in for a couple of days with a sink, bottle of shampoo, and a dream. What do you think I should see? Can I ask you a couple of questions about shampoo?
Want to try great shampoo?
Pert Plus. This is reformulated Pert Plus. It's got water-based conditioning. Okay, fine. She looks great. How do I look? You know, one thing I can say, Las Vegas has the most uneven pavement I've ever seen in my life.
My dad taught me what it means to be a true fan. What it means to come out and give 110%. Right, Dad?
Yeah!
I'm more the quiet type.
Oh, yeah!
Well, the cold doesn't bother me so much. It's the chili dogs.
Oh.
That's why I bring out the Rolaids.
Rolaid starts to neutralize acid in less than 10 seconds, getting you back on your game fast.
It's just like Grandpa always says. You gotta be your best out here.
Rolaids, R-O-L-A-I-D-S, spells relief.
Mom doesn't make it out to the games. I don't know why.
Brent Venables trying to rally this Oklahoma defense. 25-24, Ole Miss down a point, faced with third down and two from the Oklahoma 32. Les Binkley getting the right leg loose. Flags come down. From the part of the field that would indicate Oklahoma had too many men on the field.
There they go, substitution. 12 men on the field on the defense.
Oh, my goodness.
First down.
What a costly penalty there on the Oklahoma defense, especially coming out of a timeout. They're making last-minute adjustments.
Third down and short just became first and 10. Bob Stoops is obviously upset right now. A Sooner player did leave the field after the flag and after the play was stopped.
What a costly penalty.
McAllister not going very far. This is not a sure thing in terms of field goals. They're still about 45, 46 yards away in field goal range.
You see Binkley warming up his leg, 15 to 17 on the season with a long of 49.
He's hit some big kicks this year, Gino. Sanford trying to hold on to the ball. Josh Heupel can only watch. And the clock is rolling down. Third down. Now, Ole Miss is letting it roll down. It's at the left hash. And it looks like the Rebels are going to bring on Les Binkley. And with a down to burn, they call the timeout, Gino, with 3 seconds left.
I think if I'm going to attempt the field goal on third down, I don't wait that long to call the timeout. Give myself two chances.
Gino, we've just been informed that it's New Year's, baby.
Happy New Year's, East Coast.
It's the furthest thing from Les Binkley's mind. But Happy New Year. Glad to see we still have transmission. Les Binkley hit a 40-yarder to beat Memphis. He hit a 45-yarder to send the Auburn game into overtime, a game in which Ole Miss won.
Rich, special teams have been so critical in bowl games. We've seen a lot of blocked kicks already, missed field goals. What a way to end the millennium.
Timeout, Oklahoma. They will try to burn the timeout. It gives me an opportunity to thank the entire ESPN crew here in Shreveport. Our camera folks have done a wonderful job tonight. A difficult night to work with a lot of families across the country. A bunch of people that have worked with us, Gino, throughout the year. It's our final game together. Scott Garifo, Susie Hinsdale, Russ Lipkin, Tony Britt, my statistician, Ryan Church, our spotter. SportsCenter is coming up. The celebration has started on the East Coast. Ole Miss will have to wait another 3 seconds.
What a super game. I tell you what, after the first half, we weren't too sure if Oklahoma's going to be able to climb back into the ball game, but they clawed their way back into it, never panicked, just kept coming out. The defense stepped their game up, and it brought the level of play for the Oklahoma offense up to take the lead late in this ball game.
Les Binkley. For the win. It is up. It is good. Ole Miss wins it. The Rebels have won their fourth straight ball game.
What a clutch kick by Les Binkley. Rich, I don't know what it is. We've had some outstanding games this year. What a way to end the millennium with a game with a last-second field goal for Ole Miss to win this ball game.
These two schools started playing football in the 1800s. Nine national championships between them. They had never met on the football field until the final game of this century. And this ball game lived up to it.
It's good snap, good hold. Binkley puts it up, stripes that one right down the middle.
Binkley hit a bunch of big kicks this year. None bigger than this one.
He knows right when he kicks it, too. Hey, that ball, if it doesn't get blocked, it's going right through the uprights.
Rebels win their second consecutive Sanford Independence Bowl. 8-4 on the season. David Cutcliffe and his Rebels are winners tonight. But Oklahoma put up a tremendous fight. For Don McPherson and Gino Toretta, I'm Rich Waltz. Ole Miss wins a thriller. Bring on New Year's. Bring on Sports Center. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.
This has been a presentation of ESPN, proud to celebrate another moment from our first 20 years. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the Go Network. Go.com. ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.